chat with a medical provider online, and if appropriate, you'll be prescribed the ED medication that's best for you. And it'll be shipped free to your door in discreet packaging. Simple. Plus, Hims gives you unlimited follow-up visits with medical providers. Get your confidence back at forhims.com. Love your results or your money back. To get started today, go to forhims.com/radio. That's forhims.com/radio for your free visit. forhims.com/radio.
KFC knows that when it comes to chicken sandwiches, there's good and there's finger-licking good.
A chicken sandwich? That's good. A 100% white meat KFC chicken sandwich so delicious it forces you to rethink everything you know about sandwiches, including whether or not they even need buns, but then you remember how good a brioche bun can be and then having to rethink your rethinking? That's finger-licking good.
KFC's chicken sandwich, always served hot and crispy, in your choice of classic or spicy. Order now on the KFC app. Kentucky Fried Chicken. That's finger-licking good.
Prices and product availability may vary.
With prices soaring at the pump, filling up can be stressful. That's why Discover has your back with cash back. Use Discover to earn 5% cash back at gas stations and Target, now through June, on up to $1,500 in purchases when you activate. We know every dollar matters right now, but you can count on us. Get up to $75 cash back this quarter with your Discover It card. Limitations apply. Learn more at discover.com/rewards.
Listen for the screwball of the day this week on Unsportsmanlike Conduct. Could be someone screwy or nutty, but worthy of the screwball of the day title. Brought to you by Screwball Peanut Butter Whiskey, the original peanut butter whiskey, now available near you.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
A crossover is...
Crossover dribble.
Sing for the crossover.
Kyrie Irving. Crossover in the lane.
One of the most famous crossovers of all time.
Behind the back, an ankle breaker on Chris Paul.
Crossover.
Crossover. Double crossover.
The crossover continues to evolve.
Crossover. All right, time for the crossover where Tom Cruise this past weekend brought aviators back.
And mustaches.
Aviators and mustaches.
Aviators
cool.
Never went anywhere.
I don't know.
Listen.
All right, pool boy.
Listen.
Hey, before you trample on Oakleys.
Oh, listen, Oakleys are fine. I'm not saying that they've always been the premier sunglass choice the way they were post original Top Gun and the way they're making a comeback now, but there's always been a place for a pair of aviators.
All right, poll question, and this is not polarizing at all. Who made the aviators more popular, Joe Biden or Tom Cruise?
I'm going to go with Tom.
I think Tom Cruise probably. I think Tom Cruise, most likely.
But maybe it's because I saw the movie. I've noticed more people this week wearing aviators.
See, are they wearing aviators because of the movie, or are you just noticing the aviators because you watched the movie?
That's a fair question.
Well, you're complicating there in your question back to me.
I'm sorry. It's like when you buy... Okay.
Why are they at a boat?
They're on the wharf in San Francisco.
San Francisco, baby.
Don't know if you know this, Connor, but...
Don't know if the NBA finals? Oh.
Don't know if you caught the vibe. It's a yacht casual Thursday here.
Apparently, yeah.
I'm on a boat.
He's got the floral shirt and with the linen pants and boat shoes.
Boat shoes. These are Sperry's.
Amazing.
They're topsiders.
Like it's boat casual. As
listen,
you said.
As I explained to Gary, I'll make it a shorter conversation here. I'm trying to slowly move my entire aesthetic so that it can be acceptable that I bring back the puka shell necklace.
Oh,
it's an incredible look for me.
So I think people tried that or have been trying. That
I know it's
recently.
Been creeping back into the national consciousness.
Yeah.
And I saw my opening and I'm hitting that hole.
Yeah, I think we're almost back. I mean, just based off of, I think we talked about this yesterday. We had a 90s phase. We just went through a 90s phase. So we're getting into the early
2000s phase. Yeah.
So I think it'll be 04 before you know it.
Puka shell time is back, baby.
Frosted tips?
No, never a frosted tip guy.
I was frosted tips guy.
You had to be.
No, so it's really difficult to dye Indian hair.
Really? Wait, yeah. Is that, hold on.
No,
really?
That's a real thing. If you have jet black Indian hair, it's very difficult to get it to blonde.
Interesting.
Without like frying your hair.
What about the tips? Just the tips?
In some cases, just the tips work. When dyeing Indian hair, that's not the case.
Isn't this crazy how this isn't me saying this?
Yeah, this would be on brand for Gary. You two should know better.
What?
What are you talking about?
So I know when the tips, I like went all blonde.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah. You like bleached the whole thing.
Yeah. There's a, so it was actually 2000 for a girl.
Okay.
She convinced me to go all blonde.
Okay.
But I like,
might be closer than you think then.
I, yeah, the all blonde is difficult when your hair is as dark as mine. So without just really damaging the hair in general. So won't go with the hair dye, but really, I look really good in a puka shell necklace. It goes well with my skin tone. So I'm just trying to make the whole aesthetic about that. I'm building my entire aesthetic around the puka shell.
It's a vibe for sure.
It is. Yeah, it's a vibe.
It's a vibe.
It's a vibe.
So Tom Cruise, after a movie that I think brought older people back to the movie theater, at least when I went, there were older people.
Yeah, which Josh is now mad about.
Yeah, the theater's crowded. I got old people.
We had this discussion yesterday.
Old people are asking, when did movie theaters get recliners? I have to wait. I have to wait for things.
He should have been. We should have brought him on in our discussion yesterday.
We should have, yeah.
About some people don't want your favorite team to get popular because you can still go to the game, access to tickets.
Hey.
Plus, you have lots of room.
Yeah.
You're that guy.
I am.
You were going to the movie theater before Top Gun Maverick came out. You had lots of room to spread out. Nobody's around you talking or on their phone. Now, all of a sudden, a popular movie, people, it's okay to go back in the movie theater. Josh is not happy.
It was so crowded the other day, and I hated it every second.
I understand wanting your space at a movie theater. At a sporting event, it doesn't make any sense to me because the atmosphere is everything, right?
But you reacted like a Royals fan. Like, there's still good access to Royals tickets.
You can't put the cat back in the bag from a price perspective, I have learned. That's still going to be there.
Why are you putting cats in bags?
But from the space perspective, there is some more space now at Kauffman Stadium, yes.
I'm just saying, for me, if I'm going to go to a game rather than watch on television, I'm going for the atmosphere. And most of the time, that's better with a crowd.
Yeah.
Whereas a movie theater, the crowd doesn't really add to my enjoyment of the movie most of the time.
Now, when we go to sporting events, or we go to major league sporting events, we're going out of town, which means usually we're buying a pretty good seat. We're there for the full experience. Now, if you're going to a baseball game 3-4 times a week, you're probably not always buying the best seat in the house. You want to make it affordable. You want to walk into the game and roam around a little bit.
Okay.
So for those people, it's kind of nice when there's nobody in the building and you could just stand wherever you want. You could sit wherever you want.
I don't know. Cause I go to, during basketball season, I go to basically at least a Creighton game a week.
Yeah.
And
so those little tabletop cocktail tables and the Bud Bar there, those are open on Tuesday against Texas San Antonio.
Right.
Those are not open against Villanova.
And that's a worse atmosphere than going against Villanova.
It's definitely a worse atmosphere.
I'd rather watch Texas San Antonio at the comfort of my own home than go to that game because I'm missing the whole atmosphere that makes a Creighton game fun to actually be at.
Yeah, I think there's I like both, environments.
I'm not going to a game to lounge. That's my point.
When you go to the movie theater, all I'm asking is that you act like you've been there before. Act like you've been out in public before.
See, I understand the movie take because, and I mentioned this yesterday, there is an inherent awkwardness of lying down next to a stranger.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Your legs up there.
Yeah, like because some people, I usually don't go all the way back. I get the legs up, but I leave the back upright. Uh-huh. Some people lay all
the way down.
All the way back.
They're bringing blankets.
And it gets weird.
Yeah.
I feel like every once in a while I need to do a hand check on people. Hands above the blankets, folks.
Is that better or worse than sharing the armrest with the person you don't know?
It's bad, but sometimes it's both. Sometimes you're sharing an armrest while we're lying down.
Who goes in the back?
Yeah.
You're not sharing the armrest on the Barca loungers.
Some of them are.
Really?
Yeah. There are some.
You may not be sharing an armrest, but they're next to each other close enough.
Yeah, the two.
There's arm contact or potential for arm contact.
But they go in pairs, right? They go a 2-2-2-2-2, and the twos are split.
But you still have the opportunity to be arm touching with somebody, a stranger who is lying down next to you.
That's true.
Very awkward.
All right. So, Josh, when you go to a movie and you select tickets online, where are you going for the least disruption? Where are your seats? Are you in the middle of a row, end of a row?
Back row. I can't have anyone behind me because I don't know what you're doing back there. There's lights, there's sounds.
I don't know what they're doing.
I just feel very vulnerable if someone is behind me.
So, you like being in the middle of the row?
Yes.
You're not going to the bathroom during the movie.
No.
See, I'm a frequent bathroom user.
He was so annoyed by that question. No, I'm not going.
Why would you ask me that?
No. Sometimes you have to go to the bathroom, Josh.
I've always thought that, okay, maybe for people that do have to go to the bathroom during the movie, a long movie, maybe they could have like some screens in the bathroom. So you're not missing any scenes.
Well, you got it's a real
art. It would
art.
Be nice.
You got to time it out.
Yeah.
First of all, now plan A is to, of course, not go. I do frown upon the people who do go, but sometimes you have to. And you have to really time it out. It's getting slow. You come back and you can't ask the question because you can't talk.
What I miss.
I was like, I'm not going to tell you, you know. So it's very tricky.
There's an art to this because I almost anything over 2 hours, I almost always have to pee. It's a condition. I don't know what it is. I just pee all the time. So there is an art to timing your it's a diabetes thing. Don't ask. Diabetics pee all the time. It's a real thing.
Okay. Sounds like an excuse.
No, it's a blood sugar thing. Your body's trying to get rid of the excess sugar. I swear to God, it's real. So you have to, there's an art to timing it, right? So usually after a big climactic scene of some kind, that's your time to go. Cause there's usually a slowdown there because they don't go boom, boom, boom action. Yeah. So you time it out after a big action scene or after a big, like confrontation, if it's not an action movie or whatever, that's usually your time to go because there's usually a little bit of exposition you can go without and kind
recap
of
recap of the confrontation.
One, they reset, right? Mm-hmm. They kind of reset the scene for you. So that's a key time to go. Here's the other trick that I've used sometimes is this doesn't work if you want to go opening weekend, but if you go with somebody who's seen the movie already, then they can fill you in on what happened real quick.
Yeah, give you. Or they could tell you specifically, hey, now's the time.
They can tell you when to go. I go to movies with my brother a lot, and he kind of gives me a nudge when it's bathroom time.
You're gonna go, it's time.
Yeah, it's like, you've got to, if you need to empty the tank, now's a good moment.
So you got to get the Run Pee app.
I've heard about this. Yes.
Yeah. It lets you know when is the best time to go.
Yeah, that's a great idea. That's a great app.
I think that's a terrific idea.
But then you got to pull up in your phone, right? Or does it like warn you?
No, you could know beforehand.
Yeah.
Like it'll probably tell you after this happens.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but then you have this long.
Do you get spoiled?
It would be mild, I think. It would be.
So I like to, you know, because
there's some problems there.
There are. But I like to freelance it and try and feel it out myself and see how good I am at it.
I think that's the best way to
see how good I am at the game.
Yeah.
I don't know why they don't have screens in the bathroom.
So you got a lot of different movies going on.
Well, you could have up on the wall. You got 8 screens.
Wow.
That's true.
I've looked up the Run P for Top Gun Maverick.
Yeah.
There is none.
This is the most difficult movie I've ever done this for.
Oof.
There is no P time that I would recommend.
Wow. Oh, my gosh. So I need to.
Blockbuster.
I'm going today.
You look like you are.
If you can stand to miss the homage to the classic volleyball scene, that would be the best time.
Oh, can't no. You can't do that.
I might have to. Oof.
You'd miss Miles Teller's abs.
That's why you bought the ticket, right?
Say abs or ass?
Oh. Abs.
Okay. I might have to get one of those stadium buddies or something. Maybe develop some other solutions.
The other
here.
Thing you might run into, because I saw this yesterday, like I'm glad the movies are back. Like we have a summer blockbuster.
I love going to movies.
Again, I noticed that there are older people that are going to this movie. I mean, tough to make a sequel 36 years later.
What's the seat button do?
But you might want to stop by your favorite Dollar Tree to load up on candy.
Hell yeah.
As most do.
Oh, I don't do that.
But they're running out of popcorn.
See, that's an issue. I love popcorn.
Running out.
They are running out of theater popcorn.
Never seen that before.
I always get popcorn at a theater. That's part of the experience for me. I do try and select theaters where I can apply my own butter because that's important.
How many of those do you find?
Not a lot. There's only a couple around town. One of my RIP, the Oakview AMC, pour one out.
Yeah.
They were my favorite. But
they let you do your own butter?
Oh, yeah. They had the stations out. It was incredible. Because now I have to explain.
It was a sticky mess every time you
roast. Now I have to explain to a 17-year-old that I want a medically irresponsible amount of butter on my popcorn.
6 pumps.
No, 6. No, it's a button. There's no pumps. It's a button.
Oh, I thought it was in the pump.
No. You're thinking of the ketchup. There's a button.
I always thought the butter was in there. Anyway, but I don't get the butter. The butter is too much.
The butter's perfect.
We like to watch our waistline.
it's
not
perfect.
About it. It's just the butter.
It's delicious, and I love it. So,
give me all the salt in the world.
I kind of have to tell them if they're new. I can tell if they're new, too. I kind of say, hey, so what I need you to do is I need you to use the layering technique with the butter. You can't just put all the popcorn in and then butter on top.
Yeah, no.
What is that? It's like not putting cheese on the first couple layers of nachos. That doesn't work. right? So you got to go about a quarter of the way, butter, quarter of the way, butter, yeah. Layer it all the way up.
In the bottom
so
half.
So supply chain woes is. Are creating a popcorn shortage.
Wow.
Oof. What is you there remember, not a shortage of?
But do you remember when, so there's not really, in the world of popcorn, it's probably only the only place now that I get popcorn outside of my own home if mm-hmm. I want to. Or, you know, you once in a while you get it at the grocery store, you're like, you know what? Goodrich looks good.
We get we'll it. You're rich.
but when the shutdown of the movie theaters was going on, I know Exarban Cinema
would still sell movie popcorn.
They would sell movie popcorn yeah. mm-hmm. and you could drive up and yep. they would give you a bag of movie popcorn, yeah. which doesn't taste like any other popcorn.
I did that during the
special,
pandemic.
Very special.
There's a special ingredient. I can't remember what it's called, but they pour it on there. It's a. It in the popping process, it makes it taste different. Plus, then you have the butter, which is
well, and it's in the oil popper. Yeah. You know, like that's important.
It's not a microwave pop.
Microwaves at home or air poppers, which takes a lot of the not oils the same. That you need.
Yeah. Not the same.
Then you got to really doctor that thing up in order to get the experience that you want.
Oh yeah, movie theater popcorn is elite. It's the best.
So when you guys are watching movies at home, say with somebody else, your significant other, and let's say they like tune out or they fall asleep.
Mm-hmm.
What's your reaction? Or are you the person who tunes out and falls asleep?
I don't fall asleep usually.
You better not. Better not fall asleep watching a movie on my watch.
Unless it's a movie if they wanted to watch the movie and I just simply don't care.
Mm.
And I'm just there to spend time with my wife in this situation, I suppose. I don't usually fall asleep during movies. But if they do, I don't care.
I care.
Why would I care?
My wife and I both fell asleep during Jurassic Park last night. We'd just seen it so many times.
Why are you watching? Did you have it on to fall asleep to or?
No.
Well,
no,
so that's a different conversation.
That's a different deal.
We were watching it in order to prep for the new one coming out next week.
When I was single, I would fall asleep to Moneyball every night.
Every night?
Oh. Every night. That's why I know the movie so well. It's perfect because it's Aaron Sorkin movies are perfect to fall asleep to because they're just all talking.
It's all talking.
You don't have like a surprise explosion or anything. Nothing. All walking and talking, very yeah. peaceful.
That I don't tracks, know if I'm watching a movie with somebody, they're falling.
Why?
They're,
how does that affect your experience?
It does. It just how? Does because like, well, I don't watch movies that much in the first place, so I feel like,
well, if they fall asleep on you, I can see that.
No, mm-mm. If they fall asleep in general,
just in your vicinity.
If I'm taking the time out to watch this movie, we're watching it together as an experience, like. You're not falling asleep. This is the thing that we're doing.
Will you actively wake your wife up if she falls asleep?
I'll start staring at her. Yeah.
You try and wake her up yeah. with your mind. Yeah, what's like, happening? Yeah.
What the hell's wrong with you?
You should 1000% take the time to watch The Shawshank Redemption.
I know.
You haven't watched Shot? What?
Yeah, well, it's been on the docket here for like 30 years, but it's also been on the docket for 2 weeks.
Wow.
The reason he wanted to do the podcast. We're doing it.
I wanted to watch Shawshank Redemption.
Wow.
And he you can't get it done.
As Josh would say, watch. I'm busy waiting for Gary Sharp to give me error calls as he's the official scorer last night at the at Warner Park. Still waiting.
Well, we had a pop. The first play of the game was a pop-up in foul territory. Yeah. And
that one was quick. That
Jimmy
was
Govan
fun.
Dropped it. I'm like, really, is this going to be our night? I've fallen asleep. I fell asleep on a date at a movie. I was just so tired. And it wasn't that the movie was bad. Yeah, I was so tired. And I was like out.
My wife fell asleep on one of our early dates. We were at Stir Concert Cove. Actually, we both fell asleep, to be fair.
At a concert?
Yeah. So we were at Stir Concert Cove. It was AJR and Foster the People. And we had both had a couple beverages. And it was kind of that time of night where it was warm, but it was kind of cooling off a little bit. And Foster the People, we had mostly gone for AJR because we both really like AJR. But Foster the People had this song, and we knew basically the one Foster the People song, the Pumped Up Kick song that everybody knows.
Yeah.
And I knew basically,
there's more songs than that, but yes.
I basically knew zero other Foster the People songs. And one of their songs apparently has like a 10-minute instrumental in the middle.
Sure.
And like, you know, right. You're laying in the cove, you've got like your blankets or whatever you're laying out.
Wait, so like, are you on the hill?
Yeah, we were on the hill.
Like, I'll roll down the hill.
I did. Well, no, you're not laying sideways down the hill.
That's a really uncomfortable place to like be laying down.
It wasn't super comfortable, but between the drinks and we had both worked that day, it was a school night, as they say.
Mm.
And We had both worked a long day, and we got there. We got a couple of drinks in us, and then they were playing this like kind of nice instrumental, and both just kind of fell asleep. And we both woke up about the same time, and we're kind of like looked at the other person because we were sort of embarrassed that we had fallen asleep.
Did you check if you've been like robbed or anything like that?
No, it's fine. I don't think anybody else noticed around us.
Oh, nice.
And we both kind of realized we both fell asleep, and we were good to go.
That's okay if you both do, I guess, because you know. You're not bothering the other person.
How does it bother you? Like,
it just does. This is supposed to be an experience that we have together, and you're asleep. Now it's just my experience. Who do I have to talk about it with?
Josh. You text Josh during the movie.
Yeah, text me.
I don't want to text. I don't want to get out my phone.
We'll text him immediately after the movie.
I'm awake. Don't worry.
Okay, I usually do that anyway. But
speaking of talking about a movie afterwards, I think there should be like a room that people could go into if you have things to say about a movie.
Like at the movie theater?
Yeah, like, you know, it's a movie that makes you think.
Like a conference room.
Like afterwards, instead of your significant other going, as you're walking out, like a group. Like you sometimes go to the bathroom at the end of a movie and you know, people that were in the same theater
as
you. Hey,
how about that? I didn't see that coming.
I would like a little, like, we could have like a 5-10 minute forum.
I knew he was going to die 10-20 minutes in the movie.
That's actually part of the experience with my brother when we go to movies, is we basically stand out by the car for 20 minutes or whatever after we get out of the movie and have a conversation about the movie.
You're going to have a conversation after you go today.
I'm excited.
That's one of the great things about going to movies in general. It's the crowd atmosphere, like going to you know, those last two Avengers movies. That was insane. You had to see that in the movie theater.
That is one of the experiences where a crowd at the movie theater enhanced the experience. Most movies, I don't feel any different whether there's a lot of people in the theater or I'm all by myself. But Endgame especially, that last kind of battle scene with Thanos, there's a couple moments in there where there were actual cheers during the movie. And absolutely, that was really fun. That was really enjoyable.
I thought Batman was like that a little bit too. It was so dark. It was just dark. Just the darkest room with the darkest screen that you could possibly imagine.
Yeah, I didn't enjoy that movie much.
Now, nobody enjoyed that movie.
All of this discussion going to a movie.
you can enjoy it.
Hey, when the four of us see the Progressive commercial where they all go to the movie theater, you know, don't be like your parents.
Oh, yeah.
How many people look at all of those instances and go, yeah.
Done that.
Somebody goes, now, you know, drinks and popcorn, that's going to be expensive. You have to go to the bathroom first.
No, I'm still going to complain about it every time.
And the coat wrangler, I've been part of that before. Hey, just pass your coats down here. But then,
I literally have done the complaining thing on the radio show because I went to a movie, or I think I went to the Batman. And it was me and my buddy, and we got like a huge popcorn and two drinks, and it was $26 or something like that. And then I came on the radio the next day. I'm like, what happened? What happened to us as a society?
It's the best popcorn of your life. It's worth it. It was every penny.
It's not worth it. It's really good, but it's not worth $25.
I'd pay twice that.
I'll be curious. No one in my theater did it. This is something Robbie and I were talking about yesterday. The last time you were in a movie theater where people cheered?
Probably Avengers.
Endgame. Endgame for me. Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
But I think...
Because it used to happen more regularly.
It did.
It was a thing people did, and then at the end, people would like clap
or if
whatever.
It was a good movie, they would clap.
So what year did that... What, that was like 18?
2018, Endgame came out.
So I think I've probably only seen about 5 movies in the movie theater since then.
So I think there was an... I actually think people cheered. I'm trying to remember.
The pandemic hardened a lot of us.
Yeah.
It was a tough couple of years.
But now it's bringing back the older people.
And the last movie that I saw in the theaters for a long time was Uncut Gems. And that movie sucks.
Uncut Gems?
No, it's great. It's horribly tense.
Yeah, that movie sucks.
Okay, if you have anxiety, I can see it.
This is a bad movie.
No.
Yeah, see,
It's for no reason.
I think Happer
spoiler alert,
and I...
they could have shot that guy in the first 10 seconds of the movie.
I think Happer and I have a similar gauge of, okay, this may have been a well-made movie, but I'm not enjoying watching this.
Yeah, because you made you uncomfortable. That's what a movie's supposed to do.
Oh, no, it's not fun.
I'm supposed, on some level, I want
I'm not talking about it being fun or not fun.
I
wouldn't
watch when it came out on
fun.
Christmas Eve.
Celtics picked up that dub, though.
I saw it on
though.
Christmas Day. And that was the last movie I saw in the theater for
not
2 years.
Not a Christmas movie.
not a Christmas movie.
No, I think... I can acknowledge that a movie is well made and very talented people involved and whatever, and still not enjoy it. Like, enjoy the watching experience. On some level, I want to enjoy my watching experience. That's why, like,
I'm down for like a, I'm down for an emotional roller coaster. Like, I'm down for a sad movie. I'm down for
sad movies are fine.
A really dark movie, but I just didn't think that movie was good.
No, that's fair.
It wasn't just the fact that I didn't enjoy it. I was just like, you could, it was telegraphed from the very beginning. Mm. This guy's a wild card, but for some reason, we know exactly what he's going to do next at every step of the way.
I mean, how are they knocking a movie that had Kevin Garnett and Mike Francesa in it?
Now, Francesa was great.
You didn't see that Furby coming. Don't pretend.
That game, by the way, that is centered in around that movie was like on the 10-year anniversary.
Yeah, it was like a couple days ago.
Yeah.
There you go.
Celtics to win the tip.
That's what we need to bring back. We need more cheering in movie theaters at the end of a movie, not during.
I agree.
Yeah, I could go for that.
But you will get a special message from Tom Cruise before the movie begins.
Uh-oh.
Yes, so he comes on screen, and it's a personal message.
Like, ooh, well, that actually
not
probably,
that person.
No, he basically says, thank you. He goes, this movie was made for you. He briefly mentions how long it took to make it, and he said, I hope you enjoy it. So it's kind of weird.
That's awesome.
Because they go through the previews of other movies like, you know, Jurassic Park coming out.
Mission Impossible,
Mission Impossible that's coming out next year has a long trailer in this, and then so the it ends, and all of a sudden the screen goes dark, or in my theater did, and Tom Cruise is on the screen. You're like, oh, but I thought that something had broken.
Didn't see that
because there was a long pause.
Hey, I'm Tom Cruise. It's time to leave.
Doing Tom Cruise stuff. I'm actually not a huge Tom Cruise fan. I'm excited for this movie. I liked the first one. I like 80s Cruise a lot.
Yeah.
I don't love like mid-90s and later Cruise. I did love Edge of Tomorrow. Was that the weird time travel movie? That was a good one.
Yeah.
Aside from that, I don't love the Mission Impossible franchise. Just have a hard time getting on board with a lot of Tom Cruising.
Do you like the daring Tom Cruise, the friendly Tom Cruise, the arrogant Tom Cruise, or the really, really bad Tom Cruise, like in Collateral?
I don't know. Whatever.
Volleyball Tom Cruise.
Well, I'll say volleyball Tom Cruise is obviously top of the totem pole.
Sweaty volleyball Tom Cruise.
Number one draft pick.
Is he wearing jorts? I'm in.
Number one draft pick is jeans playing volleyball Tom Cruise. after that, I do love A Few Good Men. Love that movie. I enjoy Cocktail. Good film. So whatever Cocktail, Top Gun, and A Few Good Men.
Tropic Thunder.
Whatever those three have in common, that's the Tom Cruise I like.
See, there are some, Dave and I were talking about this last week about Ray Liotta. Liotta, who passed away.
Liotta.
I know. rest in peace. I have something else in my head.
Okay.
I don't think Hollywood didn't know what to do with him.
Right, yeah.
Like, with Ray Liotta?
Yeah. Ray Liotta, yes.
He was definitely...
Ray Liotta?
He was yes, Ray. He was typecast, you know. He was...
Yeah, what do you do with a guy who can act mad really well? Because, you know, like, okay, you're going to a place that you've probably been to when cameras aren't rolling, sir.
Did he ever show up in a movie that was a little bit lighter, but he had to still be sort of an angry...
Heartbreakers.
Mobster. And then, you know, he threw in a joke or two or something like that too. Like, mm-hmm. I think that would be a good role for him because when you see him on the Robert De Niro roles in some of his later movies.
When
you see him on the screen, you're like, oh, this guy, you know.
He's an intimidating presence.
Right. There's some shady stuff.
But
going
he's
on
also got Field of Dreams on his resume.
Oh. True. People forget about Field of Dreams.
Ray Liotta is in Cocaine Bear coming out next year.
Oh.
It's a movie called Cocaine Bear.
Wonder what
so it will be the
that.
Awkwardness of a movie comes out and somebody in it is no longer with us, i.e. Batman.
Question about Cocaine Bear.
Yes.
Is this a Build-A-Bear?
How much?
It is not.
This is mostly a joke for Happer.
I was at the Mall of America and the Build-A-Bear shop was popping.
It was popping?
Oh my God. Out the door.
And could you fill the bears with cocaine?
I wonder if that's an option at the Build-A-Bear.
You could sneak it in there. The 17-year-old working the Build-A-Bear doesn't care.
He's like, that's kind of cool.
Sandwich baggies in there. That's neat.
So Happer and I used to have this discussion frequently about, you know, the relative strength of bears versus either other animals or humans. And I'm wondering where a bear on cocaine ranks on that list, because I think that takes it to another level.
It's all about the want, you know, for the bear. Does the bear want to destroy us? The bear could.
That's true.
Although I did see a video yesterday or 2 days ago, maybe, of a bear was trying to eat like a baby moose, and then the big moose like chased it out. Oh,
I did see that. Yeah,
that was a great video.
Well, I think it was. I think that was a baby bear to start, so the moose was much larger.
Right, but
so that was an issue.
The bear did not see the moose.
No,
he didn't see that coming.
The bear ski-dadded pretty quick out of there.
He ran into a glass window.
He did, and he was like, "Oh crap!" I will say, most of the videos I send Happer are just to prove that bears aren't hostile. They're mostly of bears just chilling, doing like stoner stuff.
Yeah, they play in Chicago. Thank you. That's, sticking to sports.
Nice. That's the thought, though. Like, if bears wanted to.
Yeah. If bears chose.
But it depends on what. Are they coming off the cocaine high?
That's true.
Like, are we. If you get them at the beginning of the cocaine high, then you're in trouble.
Like, are we at the beginning of Goodfellas or the end when everything's going to crap with the cocaine? You see what I did there?
Tied it all around. Ray Liotta was in Muppets Most Wanted, where he plays a character named Big Papa. So I'm going to assume he played Ray Liotta in a comedy setting.
Good. I have seen that film.
I think that's the one that I haven't seen.
I have seen that one.
Yeah, it's the one that I haven't seen.
Just the one?
Just the one.
The Muppets were prolific for a while.
They were.
A lot of films.
They were. They're on Holy Moly right now, too.
All right.
You getting something there?
Oh, no. I'm just reading a
He's just checked out on Sean Kelly conversation.
Oh. Explaining their...
Gary's no longer interested in this.
I'm not sure. No, I just that's somebody who is, you know, has a little issue going on right now.
He does.
I have his number too. I can text him.
We haven't heard from him in a couple days.
He's been busy, I think. Got some things going on.
I wonder when we'll hear from him. So
Sip said by the end of the day.
Sipple's the only employee at his company at the moment.
Employee number one.
Wow.
That's right.
You think he got stock options?
Sipple running the whole message board.
Oh, that sounds right.
It's a beautiful thing.
I feel like he would really love that.
We failed to ask him.
What is his name on the board?
Oh yeah, we should have got his handle.
Now he has to have a burner too.
So you got to have your. I think everybody has their own.
Yeah, you have to have your authorized account, your verified SIP account. But then you have to have. I think you have to have a burner.
Here's the thing that I'm trying to do. I guess I'll say this on the radio. I won't post anything crazy, but I think it's on Reddit and a couple of those message boards. I am Runza Fries. But I don't post anything on there. I just am on there lurking, as they say.
Oh, you're a lurker.
Yeah, a lurker. Wow. But I go by the screen name Runza Fries.
You look like a lurker.
I am a lurker. Just like to see what's going on in there.
Why Runza Fries?
I don't know. I like Runza Fries.
Okay.
I thought that was a good enough reason.
Self-explanatory. I like it.
I could have done Frings, I suppose, too.
Frings are a nice option. Get a little bit of both. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We were telling...
every once in a while.
Telling our friend, was it Kendall we were talking to? Yeah. That he'd never had a Runza. And I was like, listen, even if you don't like the Runza, there's other good options.
Great burgers.
Great burgers.
Great burgers.
Great fries. Great onion rings.
Yeah, that's why we got to get Alan Bell here.
Bell.
And Top End Ranch. Very good ranch.
My wife is crazy about their ranch.
I'm not a huge, like, I love ranch guy, but I do understand when there's a quality ranch against a non-quality ranch, for sure.
Very high quality ranch at Runza.
It's good.
Aren't you required, if you're born in Nebraska, to, like, be bathed in Dorothy Lynch? Don't you have, like, baptism?
Not a Dorothy Lynch guy.
I didn't even, like, try that out until college.
I didn't know much about Dorothy Lynch until it became, like, a major sponsor of Nebraska football. I thought, well, okay, there's some things you're supposed to do as a native Nebraskan.
I started going to the lunches at the, you know, the press conferences, and they had the big old bowl of Dorothy Lynch.
Oof.
It's kind
of a Nebraskan if you don't like Dorothy Lynch.
It's pretty good.
I think that says it in the commercial.
So you got the plate, and you have the little salad, and then you have a couple slices of Valentino's pizza, and maybe you have a little bit extra Dorothy Lynch.
Are you a dipper?
You can dip the pizza in the Dorothy Lynch.
Yeah,
but the pizza's the pizza's already, like, you know.
I'm a ranch dipper. I'll dip pizza in ranch, but I'm not dipping it in Dorothy Lynch.
I don't knock it till you try it.
I will knock it.
Oh, don't knock it till you try it.
But I will, and I probably won't try it. That sounds terrible. It's a texture issue for me.
What's the difference in texture.
Dorothy Lynch is a thicker dressing. I don't like a thick dressing.
I'm just talking about the like the remains of it. It's not like a full on dunk.
It's, so it's like when you're
whatever's
dipping,
left from the salad.
It's like when you're dipping in pico de gallo, but you don't get any tomato.
That's it.
You just get the
juice sort of.
Okay, that makes sense.
It's not too cumbersome.
Because I don't like a thick dressing.
Yeah. No, I'm with you there.
It's bad. Not good. I don't like it.
I wish there was a transcript of all of our crossovers.
Josh tries to keep pretty close track.
But like an actual transcript. Like, you know, like if you're doing closed captioning of the crossovers, there would be people you wouldn't understand.
I think there's an app you can do that, like on your live stream. You can get them closed captioned.
There's like radio salespeople go around the country and they're like, we have this.
We can close caption for you.
Or like, this seems like it'd be a really great thing for some uses, but a horrible thing for others.
I would prefer someone sitting in that corner over there, like courtroom like a stenographer situation. Yeah. Exactly.
They're tapping away.
We could maybe do that, like for course credit.
We should hire one for a show, for a crossover.
Hire one for an entire show.
Yeah.
And then at certain times, pause and go,
can you read that back to me? Yeah,
what was that take I had about
an argument with somebody? Be like, excuse me, can you read that back?
I didn't say that. Yes, you did. Okay, let's go to the
I don't give the radio people enough credit. We're basically writing like 18 columns a show. Mm-hmm. Sipple's talking about pumping out 4 columns a week on his new internet website.
On the interwebs.
We're like, hey, man, everything we got's a column.
No, the most
4 hours every day.
The Sean most tweeted. Writing I've done as an adult is writing out solo shows for the midday.
Yeah.
Like that is the most amount of writing I've done as an adult, I think.
Yeah. Well, you got
post college at least. Yeah.
You gotta really think some things out.
Yeah, that's pretty, if you want to feel prepared, it's pretty extensive. I mean, you guys know.
Thoughts, Gary?
These fellas know.
I don't know whether a team show or a solo show. I don't really write what I'm going to say, but I have bullet points of what I definitely want to talk about. Mm-hmm. So that's why you guys make fun of me for writing things out.
No. I make fun of you that it's not on a computer.
No, because I don't. So here's the deal. When I sit down in the morning, the afternoon, at night, I like to write. I've always liked to write because
you just like the physical act of it.
Yeah. I mean, I don't have a problem typing, but sure. I don't want to sit here and have to scroll. I like the physical where...
Just turn the page.
Yeah. Boom. And I'm also a guy, because I'm a list person, the sense of accomplishment of crossing something.
Oh, yeah.
Josh is a huge fan of that. He's got a little list every day.
Right here.
Yeah, I mean, there's like a rewarding day when you can cross things off your list. So I make lists. I used to be, I'd make lists, and then I'd make more lists, and I'd make more lists, and I'd forget about the first list, and just continue to make lists. As the procrastinator in me,
the last item on the last list is go back to first list.
But first list. Crossing things off a list is like a rewarding. Like,
I'll give you that.
Yes,
there's actually science behind that. They've like hooked people's brains up. There's actually a like serotonin release. Serotonin. Like it's not just in your head. It's a thing that's actually happening. That's why they encourage it.
I am still this way, but I used to be super spontaneous and I wouldn't write anything down. I just fly by the seat of my pants. And then as you get a little bit older and you have responsibility, you have to write things down.
Hey, look, none of us here are doing it. This is just the act of typing it onto a computer or not.
I just like to write. That's all. I'm a writer.
Gary just likes to write.
You're a pecker. I'm a writer.
That's the crossover, ladies and gentlemen. Start things off next.
That's the crossover. The Connor Happer Show is next on 1620 The Zone. The Connor Happer Show.
These are the quarterbacks that they've got committed just under Ryan Day. Quinn Ewers, who was the number one quarterback in the class of 2021, he since transferred out.
Quinn?
Yeah.
I don't like that name for a quarterback. Quinn, not strong enough. But please, proceed.
Excuse me, Quinn?
Quinn?
Yeah, get over it. He's going to be the quarterback at Texas this year.
Oh, no shot.
He's like the highest rated quarterback of all time.
3-9 confirmed.
Yeah, Quinn Ewers.
Weekdays from 10 to 2 on 1620, The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast presented by Funplex Water Park and Rides from the KETV Newswatch 7 Weather Center on 1620, The Zone.
Mostly sunny and warm for your Thursday with a high today in Omaha near 80 degrees with low humidity. Expect an afternoon breeze with westerly winds up to 20 miles an hour. Tonight, becoming partly cloudy, a tad cool with a low near 53 and light winds. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KETV Newswatch 7.
Email on sportsmanlike conduct on the Equitable Bank Zone inbox with whatever is on your mind, from your hot takes to what you think is one. The Zone inbox is brought to you by Equitable Bank. We take banking personally. We want to hear from you on the Equitable Bank Zone inbox.
Meet Caitlin and Adrian, a just married couple that loves each other almost as much as I love windows. As a dedicated Pella window and door replacement advisor, I help guide them through our quality options and decide on the right choice for their style and budget.
Get more with Pella. Let us personalize an offer just for you. Visit PellaOmaha.com/radio for more details.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job in ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And right now you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free at ZipRecruiter.com/radio. That's ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter.com/radio.
For thousands across the heartland, summer means one thing: hunger. Having extra mouths to feed, paired with the rising cost of food, puts an additional strain on already tight budgets. Families need your support now more than ever. Stop by the Food Bank for the Heartland's Stuff the Truck event on Saturday, June 11th at the Baker's Lakeside location off 173rd and Center from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Your donations of non-perishable items will fill tables with food and hearts with hope. Help the Food Bank strike out hunger this summer.
You want 8 of the flutes and onyx.
Jira's hand-blown glassware blows right off her store's shelves.
Back for more indigo bowls.
She needs an inventory manager to help keep her stock on lock.
These are 100% porous silicate. Those aren't. Hey, can someone check the temp on the kiln?
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. We instantly connect you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job description. Earn up to $500 in sponsored job credits by conducting interviews on Indeed. Visit Indeed.com/credit. Terms and conditions apply.
At the United States Postal Service, we deliver packages fast and affordably so you can give your customers what they want when they need it. We're delivering for one-stop shops, mom and pops, pop-ups, startups, retail, wholesale, large scale, small biz, big box, customers, customizers. So no matter what business you're in, we'll always be delivering for you. USPS, delivering for America. Learn more at usps.com/delivering.
Hi, I'm Amanda Pete. Like all new parents, my husband and I want what's best for our baby. When it was time for our daughter's immunizations, we wanted the facts. So we carefully researched vaccines. We spoke with doctors and other experts and asked some tough questions. We decided that vaccines were the best thing for our child. I urge you to get the facts. Learn the facts about vaccines so you can make the best healthcare decisions for your family. Thank you.
A message from the American Academy of Pediatrics and VaccinateYourBaby.org.
Make the right call, fans. The Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard.
It's the Connor Happer Show with Connor Happer and Josh Otzen. Let's get ready to rumble.
Licensing of the phrase "let's get ready to rumble" just over the last 7+ years internationally is grossed approximately close to $400 million in retail sales.
Really?
You guys look like, what do they look like, Jimmy?
Dorks. They look like a couple of dorks.
On 1620, The Zone.
All right, here we go. Welcome in. Happy Thursday. NBA Finals Day. Josh, you're wearing a Brave shirt.
Wearing a Brave shirt.
Where's your green?
Turns out I don't have a lot of green.
Your Boston Celtics are playing in game one of the NBA Finals tonight. I don't know if you've heard or not.
And I have heard.
And everybody, I don't think I've heard one person go out on a limb yet and say, you know what? I think the Celtics have it. I think they can make this happen.
The only thing I've seen is the ESPN BPI.
Oh, yeah, that was like super lopsided.
Yeah, 86% chance that the Celtics win the series. And I went, I don't think that's right.
Seems slightly odd, yes.
Feels high.
I feel like, you know, and these 3 days sort of leading up to the finals are really fun. I like how there's a break in there because you can kind of get a feel for the matchups. You could dive deep into it and stuff like that.
You can gamble.
But gauging the public over the last few days, and the line really hasn't moved. I was looking at FanDuel this morning. I mean, still Boston's plus Happer. 130. Yes, thank you. Promo code Happer, very unique. Boston's still plus 135 for the series. Golden State plus or minus 160. I think it's been sitting there since the matchup was decided. So it hasn't moved much, but just gauging the public, I just feel like Golden State is a pretty heavy favorite here. The most common one is six games. I feel like I'm higher on Boston in this series than most. I know I've been sort of tough on them, but I mean, you got to give them a little bit of credit. They swept the Nets, which, I mean, that's not nothing.
That's right, Connor. And they beat it's something.
And they beat Milwaukee.
Defending champs. People forget that.
And you know, I think the Eastern Conference Finals, even though it went seven, was a bit of a dud, considering. But with that being said, they beat the two teams that had they met in the Eastern Conference Finals. Everybody would have been super juiced about an Eastern Conference Finals between Boston and Milwaukee or Boston and in Brooklyn. So they kind of took care of their business early. I'm leaning toward the Celtics.
I can talk myself into this by saying the Celtics have always played the Warriors tough, even during the dynasty years of the Warriors.
Yep.
Which we may or may not still be in, depending on your outlook.
They have some length that Golden State doesn't exactly on the wings. Mm-hmm. That Golden State doesn't exactly have. Obviously, you're going to get hit by the Avalanche at some point, and it's all a matter of how do you kind of sustain it. That's always going to be the question when you play the Warriors. I just wouldn't count out Boston. They have this unique way, and I like teams like this during the postseason, not from an aesthetic standpoint. And this is both in college basketball and the NBA. Not so much from an aesthetic standpoint, but from a ability to win games standpoint. Teams that can win in a lot of different ways, they can really muck it up. And
Boston can do that.
Yeah, make things really ugly. So I don't know. That sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes gives you the ability to win post games or close games in the postseason.
And no Jeff Van Gundy tonight.
Breen's out too, right?
Bang! TBD on that. I think it'd be his first finals game out since like 09 or something like terrible. That, I read. Yeah. I think he's still, his status is up in the air, but Van Gundy's out. He has now tested positive for COVID, but did not on Sunday. When if you saw and heard him, he sounded like a COVID patient.
With symptoms.
Yes.
Yes. Woj is out too.
Yes. I don't know.
I don't know what Woj would have been doing.
Other than sitting. Oh boy, great point, Greeny.
Yeah. I mean they put him on site, but he could do literally everything he does from his house. Mm-hmm. From his old, you know, apartment, wherever he's at. So no Woj and no Van Gundy. Maybe on Mike Breen. We need Breen, though. We need a good bang call to start off our June.
Yeah, especially with the Warriors in the series. You want that call.
Absolutely. So that, we have that tonight. And then tomorrow, we'll have Ravi versus Josh, the showdown. The Ravi versus Josh showdown after game one. And Ravi, a fan of the Warriors, and Josh, a Celtics guy. Maybe he'll pull a Celtic shirt out of his closet or something like that.
I don't know how many radio shows are offering you that tomorrow on post game one.
Well, all the credit goes to me because I am, you know, nice enough to step away and allow this to happen.
You said, you know what? This is my show. My name's on the marquee, but for the betterment of society,
it's time for me to step back.
I'll step away. I had a day off Monday, but I will have another one.
All right. Today on the show, we'll talk NBA finals and more. Yesterday was a big day for college basketball, with the decision for a lot of the guys who were waiting until the very, very last day, whether to keep their name in the NBA draft or not, or head back to college basketball. That expired last night. So in college basketball, I think got a lot of guys back. The Big Ten, we'll talk about that a little bit and how the draft or the lack of it affected the conference next year with Jacob Padilla of Hill Varsity here in just a minute. Sam McKewon of the World Herald, talk some Husker football with him. And in the 1 o'clock hour, Martie Cordaro, you may know him. He's around a little bit. President of the Omaha Storm Chasers in Union Omaha. He's going to join the show. It is ALS Day across Major League Baseball, Lou Gehrig's disease. And Marty's, of course, been an advocate for, you know, basically every sort of movement, and the connection to baseball and the disease is really, really special, obviously, because of Lou Gehrig. And Marty's been really involved with that stuff. So we're going to chat with him in the 1 o'clock hour. And by the way, he has two pretty good tickets in town. His teams, the Chasers, and it was a good crowd last night, almost 5,000 out at Warner Park. And then Union Omaha is probably the talk of the town, at least a little bit right now. And as we inch closer to the U.S. Open Cup semifinals. Quarterfinals.
I believe. They're getting down to the nitty gritty there.
Yes, against Sporting KC here in just a couple weeks. I have to ask him because I genuinely don't know, and maybe the soccer people out there listening might. Like if they were able to win that match, which, you know, who knows? They've already beaten two MLS teams in this tournament. Is it possible that we could get one of the bigger name brand MLS teams out at Warner Park with I genuinely don't know the answer. So we'll talk about that with Marty in the 1 o'clock hour. That is the lineup, and it's powered by the Rooferies at John Higgins Weather Guard. And there's plenty of other things to get into. ESPN came out with a quarterback tiers across the country. Casey Thompson, where is he? Adrian Martinez, where is he?
I hear he's got a talented team down there in Manhattan.
Who'd you hear that from? Source?
Yeah, I got a source within the program. It's Sean Callahan.
Mike Trout, as we predicted yesterday, was asked quite a bit. He was peppered with questions from the New York media.
This guy.
About his stupid fantasy league that has now turned into a bigger deal. And Mike Trout does the thing that Mike Trout does, which is just be a huge wet blanket and dump water over everything that he possibly can, over every fire that he can find. It's disappointing. I just one time want to see him get out the bottle of kerosene. One time, Mike. So we'll get to that later in the show. Also, Big Ten rights, another talking point today. Big Ten TV rights, as we're getting closer and closer to a resolution or a release of contract details on that is a Thursday show. It is crowded, but we'd like to see you guys involved as always. 402-951-1620. You can call or text that number. Connor at 1620thezone.com, the Equal Bank inbox. Twitter on the JTech Construction Zone Twitter feed at Connor Happer, at Happer Show. There are 7,000 different ways. And you can watch us. And you can comment on our YouTube stream like Andy. You could find that at 1620thezone.com, by the way. Andy says, you see a football on the beach, go pee then. That comment wouldn't make any sense to you if you're just joining the show now. We were trying to find out in the crossover the best time possible to pee during the new Top Gun movie. And I happen to disagree with Andy. I think that's a can't-miss scene.
Yeah, you can't miss the volleyball retread scene.
I mean, honestly, that's why you're there. It was one of the only things that I was looking for, like, when they...
Well, I mean, I watched the movie for the first time a couple of weeks ago, and we talked about it on our podcast, which you can listen to on our feed, by the way, Producer Josh's Film School. But we talked about it, and we said, well, they're going to remake the volleyball scene, right?
They do. Oh, they absolutely do.
They do. And I've seen it nonstop on my TikTok, even though I haven't seen the new movie, because the women are falling in love with Miles Teller again.
He threw a strike last night at the Phillies game.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. Wearing a
he's out there
90s style Looney Tunes baseball shirt.
When you're hot, you're hot.
Yeah.
When you're hot, you're hot.
That was a heat check, that shirt.
And the stash and the aviators are the public is enjoying it right mm-hmm. now. We'll have Jacob Padilla of Hill Varsity talk some hoops with both college and the NBA. The finals begin tonight next here on 1620 The Zone.
For the Jays, the Huskers,
and even you Jayskers,
we are 1620 The Zone.
Living is all about great experiences. We invite you to experience everything that Sarpy County has to offer. The great outdoors awaits you at Fontenelle Forest or Schramm State Park. As the pro sports capital of Nebraska, grab your family and enjoy an Omaha Storm Chasers or Union Omaha game at Werner Park. Nothing beats watching your child catch their first foul ball or perhaps a fish at one of Sarpy's many reservoirs. Visit GoSarpy.com to plan your next experience this spring.
Everyone, Josh Peterson here for my friends at Miracle Hill Golf and Tennis. It is a great time for you to get your golf game back in shape with their director of instruction, Mike Favre. Give him a call at 402-498-0220. Whether it is individual lessons, whether it is group lessons, whether you are a single handicap or have never played golf before, he can help improve the game of golf for you, and thus you will enjoy those rounds when you get out and play. They're located just north of Dodge on 120th Street, Miracle Hill Golf and Tennis.
At Woodhouse, we make car buying simple. From test drive to purchase, we're here to help guide you to your next vehicle with no pressure sales, transparent pricing, and a streamlined purchase process to save you time. Finding the place to shop for your next vehicle just got easier. Whether you're looking for a car, truck, or SUV, we will get you on the road faster with a vehicle that exceeds your expectations. Find new roads and explore all our inventory arriving daily at WoodhouseGM.com and at our dealership in Missouri Valley, Iowa.
Howdy, folks. Greg Wagner joining you from the Nebraska Game and Parks Commission. And time now for another Nebraska Outdoor Update. Hey, grab your gear and take them fishing. What do you say? Take a newcomer out fishing. Share a pic with us at Game and Parks Online, and then become eligible to win some very cool prizes. Everything from a state park cabin stay to a nice kayak. It's our Take 'em Fishing Challenge. See more about that on the Game and Parks website, outdoornebraska.org. That's outdoornebraska.org. And we have some angler reminders to pass along as well, that any of you going fishing 16 years of age or older must have a current Nebraska fishing permit signed and on your person. And you need to learn the limits for the fish you're after, where you're fishing, daily bag, possession, and length. It's all part of knowing before going. I wish you the best out there fishing. I'm Greg Wagner with Nebraska Game and Parks.
Suck it up.
It's not a big deal.
Snip out.
Just get over it.
We've all heard it. But if you're experiencing extreme stress, it's not just in your head. It can affect your entire body because toxic stress can hurt us physically without us even knowing it. If you've lost a job, worry about your next meal, or have trouble making it through the day, if you're feeling the effects of stress, we can help. Text STRESS to 211-211 to find a solution.
Hi, I'm Casey Kane. You would think that as NASCAR's 2004 Rookie of the Year, I get my biggest thrill driving fast. But it's off the racetrack that I get one of life's greatest rewards, helping others through volunteer service. Working with kids is one way that I try to make a difference. The first time I visited chronically ill children in the hospital, I found out just how rewarding volunteering could be. By giving a little of my time, it brightened their day. I was so inspired that I started my own foundation to help sick children and kids without an opportunity to have a better chance at life. Through volunteer service, you learn things about the people you're helping, and you find out a few things about yourself. Volunteering is a rush, just like taking the checkered flag. Go to volunteer.gov to find out what drives you.
This is President George W. Bush.
USA Freedom Corps has a volunteer opportunity that's just right for you. Visit volunteer.gov. When you help your neighbor, you help your nation.
Prescription products require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if a prescription is appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information. Subscription required. Refund available for 60 days after purchase.
Having an issue with ED might begin in the bedroom, but it doesn't end there. It can also do a number on your confidence. But know this, you're not alone. 30 million guys deal with ED in the U.S. Fortunately, treating ED is now more straightforward and less awkward than ever, thanks to Hims. Through Hims, you can get the generic form of Viagra, which uses the same active ingredient for just $3 per use. Just go to 4hims.com and chat with a medical provider online, and if appropriate, you'll be prescribed the ED medication that's best for you. And it'll be shipped free to your door in discreet packaging. Simple. Plus, Hims gives you unlimited follow-up visits with medical providers. Get your confidence back at 4hims.com. Love your results or your money back.
To get started today, go to 4hims.com/radio. That's 4hims.com/radio for your free visit. forhims.com/radio.
And now, the only cure for our basketball Jones. Hail Varsity's Jacob Padilla on the Connor Happer Show on 1620 The Zone, baby.
Baby! We're joined by Jacob Padilla of Hail Varsity. Talk some hoops, maybe a little bit more. Jacob, hello. How are you?
Hi, I'm doing well. How about you, Connor?
Good. How would you say college basketball in general turned out after the whole draft thing has been sifted through here? It feels like there was a lot of big names who came back to the sport. I don't know what you would credit that to. I suppose we can get into that as well. But it feels like college basketball in general is in a pretty good place with the players that it has coming back next year.
Yeah. Some of the biggest names in the sport are back. Obviously, Drew Timmy was kind of one of the final decisions there. Went down to the wire, but he's coming back, so that's a huge one. Oddly enough, like the deadline in general, the draft did not go well for the Big Ten.
But yeah.
Generally, in college basketball, it did. Like Oscar Tshiebwe, National Player of the Year, he's back, and he didn't even really go through the process. And a big part of that is the NIL portion of it, and some of the stars that aren't guys that are surefire first round picks, surefire lottery picks, realizing, hey, I got a pretty good setup here where I can come back to school, be one of the best players in the country, and make quite a bit of money in the process. So I think that definitely had a big part of it. But like I said, the only real Big Ten player that of substance that chose to come back was Trace Jackson Davis. Yep. Pretty much everybody else that tested the waters decided to stay in, at least the most important players. I mean, Caleb McConnell, the defensive player of the year for Rutgers, pulled out of the draft, but they lost Ron Harper Jr. So it wasn't a great deadline and draft cycle for the Big Ten in terms of bringing back some of their best players, but in general, there definitely were some big names that pulled out of the draft.
I mean, the NIL thing is obviously a part of it, but I think NIL has sort of been a good tool for guys to sort of realize, and you know, it comes with an obvious added benefit too, which is you can make money, and that would have been the driving factor before. But do you think it ends up being a better situation for college basketball in general? And the draft is small, and there's just not a lot of guys who go, and there's not a lot of guys who get opportunities. The NBA is a pretty tight league with tight benches, and like it's hard to break into that, especially if you are a fringe draft guy. So maybe guys have realized, hey, go back to school, give it another run, see what happens from a professional perspective after next year, but also, you know, really dive into the last year of college basketball. That's a good thing for the sport, and I think it's a good thing for the players too.
And that was part of the idea behind the NIL rules. And They wanted to combat losing many of the game's best players so quickly. And because there has been a rise in where players, even if they're not even guaranteed to be drafted, guys are just kind of ready to be down in college, ready to start making money. Well, maybe they'd reconsider if they got to do that while also continuing their college careers. We saw, heck, with Creighton, with Tyshawn Alexander and Marcus Zagorowski, yep, both back-to-back years, left a year early. And they felt like they were ready to go be pros, but maybe that calculus would have been different. So that's definitely part of the idea behind NIL. And everybody's freaking out right now about the way it's being used in recruiting and all that. But there's a lot of good things happening with it too, between that and then just kind of the general, like some of the charity events and things like that, that people are doing throughout the country using the NIL kind of rules.
Yeah. I mean, that was the initial thing, one of them anyway. There's a really good community aspect to it. And maybe the college fan bases can sort of, have a easier connection with players sort of than they ever. It doesn't have to be just straight up transactional. It could be the players sort of investing in the community as well. I don't know. I think there's a lot to that. And I don't know exactly, because you're still going to see the best guys and the most draftable guys go and jump to the NBA every year. But there is so much outside of those top, 15, 20, 30 guys that can really have an impact in college hoops.
For sure. And again, we'll continue to see. We're only a year into this NIL deal and only a few years into the one-time transfer here. So a lot of the overreactions and people panicking now, I think we'll have to wait a little bit just to see what kind of impact this really has on whatever sport, whether it be football, basketball, whatever else. We need a few years to let the market kind of correct itself, let everybody realize, okay, what is the best practices here and all that sort of thing. So, you look at it right now, how different would the landscape be next season if there wasn't NIL? The transfer deal plays a big part of it because, sure, guys are immediately eligible. But you look in football, who are going to be the best teams, and how different would that have been without NIL? The power programs are still going to be power programs just like they were before. And there'll be individual instances where NIL really helped certain schools that maybe otherwise wouldn't have had a chance, whether it's keeping their guys from transferring elsewhere or landing a guy here and there. But I'm not one that's going to, I don't see this like completely changing the landscape one way or the other. I think it'll still largely operate similar to what we've seen, just with different rules and different ways of getting there.
Yeah. Jacob Adil of Hill Varsity is with us on Nebraska basketball. Trey McGowan's made his intentions official that he's not coming back to Nebraska. We've been expecting that for, quite some time, especially with how Nebraska recruited and what they sort of did to their roster. I guess, how much of it do you think at the end, do you think they would have, said, hey, doors open for a guy like Trey McGowan's to come back? Or was it sort of, maybe this is best for everybody if, we just try something else there?
Yeah, I think they would have taken him back if he had decided kind of earlier on in the process that he was coming back. We saw they kind of struggled to fill that last spot. They went after some big fish and struck out, and ultimately landed on a guy like Emmanuel Bandomo, who slightly different style, but I think he brings some of the similar things to the table that Trey did. So they basically went out and got a Trey replacement while Trey was going through the process. So ultimately, I think if he had decided, I'm going to come back, use this extra year, I think they would have definitely had space for him. And whether they continued to go after these big guys and maybe suggested somebody look elsewhere, or they just kind of called it good with Trey coming back. I think he would have had the option to return if he wanted to. But again, he's been in college for 4 years. He got to do the thing with his brother. I don't know that he really gains much besides hopefully a healthy senior year, chance to play the whole year. I think that really would have been the only upside for him coming back. So decided, you know what, going to go see what kind of professional opportunities are out there for me now and kind of take the next step in my life.
I mean, I think we've sort of touched on this before, because like I said, it was assumed what Trey was going to do in Nebraska's roster is sort of complete. But I guess when you put the whole thing together now, and assuming there isn't any more attrition, and I don't think there will be at this point, as we, you know, get into summer school, and before you know it, they'll be, you know, firing up practices here in a couple months. What do you see when you look at Nebraska's roster that they set up for this year? I mean, regardless of what it could have been, and I think that's what people look at and they say, well, you missed on a couple big fish, and that's sort of disappointing. But taking it for what it is right now, what do you like, and what are some concerns?
Yeah, definitely right off the bat, that the concerns are like who are going to be the lead guys on this team. Do they have anybody in contention for any kind of all conference individual honors? Obviously, last year you had Bryce as your star player. And then Alonzo Verge Jr., for all his ups and downs,
yep,
the ups, he was able to get up there pretty high with those and was capable of really taking over games. So do you have a guy like that? I think a lot is riding on a guy like Sam Griso coming in as a senior transfer here. And how good can he be in year one? If he could, I mean, going from the Summit League to the Big Ten, that's a big jump. So what kind of production is he going to be able to provide? Because I think if they can count on him, he's not going to have to be a 17-point-a-game scorer like Bryce was for this team to succeed. But he's got to be a guy that consistently performs, whether 12, 13 points, 7 rebounds, 3, 4, 5 assists, something like that, just kind of a steady stat line where he's impacting the game in multiple ways and allowing others to play to their strengths as he's kind of the main playmaker. So that's kind of the question mark. And I think you look at the roster as a whole, it's definitely different than last year's. There's more size, more athleticism on the wings. I think they're going more all in on trying to pick up the defense. Obviously, hiring Adam Howard was part of that. So that's kind of where you saw where a guy like Rashawn Gary, a little undersized, but athlete, plays hard, rebounds. Denham Dawson, kind of a 3-and-D type of wing, good athlete on the wing that'll get after it on defense. Bandamel is a guy that prides himself on his defense, 6'4 guard, and Ermel Lloyd Jr., 6'6 long, can play the point, can play off the ball, and then Griso himself, also another 6'6 guard. So you got a lot of length there. You had Blaze Keita in the middle as another big body, as that backup five. That kind of that five duo with Derek Walker, you can kind of play those guys however matchups, who is playing well, whatever, you get some options there. So it's definitely a different looking roster. We'll see kind of what the talent level is. CJ Wiltshire ready to step up and do more? How good can these transfers be right away? How good are the freshmen right away? Because you look at it, it's you've got those transfers, those upperclassmen, and Griso, Bandamel, Walker, and then Keita as a JUCO guy. And then you got a lot of young guys there with Lloyd and Jamarcus Lawrence and Dawson and Wilhelm Breidenbach if he gets healthy, and Wiltshire. Some of these guys are younger players, so it'll be interesting to see kind of how those seniors lead the way and bridge the gap and hopefully help the young guys come along and be important parts of the program, both in year one and moving forward.
All right, Jacob, let's get to the finals, as we have game one tonight. I think it's a sort of fun clash in styles. I'm giving Boston a little bit more chance, I feel like, than maybe the public is right now. What's your feel going into the series and into tonight?
Yeah, I just want a good, long, competitive series, yeah, where we actually have some close games. I think basketball fans deserve that at this point after the playoffs that we've kind of struggled through so far, where there are almost no close games, very little clutch time. It's really, most games have been decided well before the fourth quarter. So hopefully we've got, I mean, Boston was the best team in the league analytically over the last half of the season or so. And we know what Golden State is capable of. So I think that this does have the potential to be a great series. And you look at Boston's makeup just with the length they have up and down the lineup, the defensive ability. I mean, you look at that starting five, there is no weak spot defensively. And then, I mean, you bring a guy like Derek White off the bench who is a strong defender, and like that's kind of the weak spot in that lineup when he's out there. And again, Derek White's a good defender, so they're the best defense in the league for a reason, and that's going to give a team like Golden State problems. They're going to make them really work. I mean, you look at the regular season, they split the series. Each team won a game. So I mean, not a ton to learn from there. Obviously, throughout the season, different guys healthy. Klay Thompson is still, kind of continuing to work his way back towards where he wants to be. Sounds like the Warriors have a chance for Gary Payton, second, Otto Porter, and Andre Iguodala all to be factors in this series, which would be a nice boost for them, obviously. That really kind of helps their depth there because they were limited on options beyond the top six or seven guys they had. And you saw Steve Kerr kind of trying different guys out to fill the gap. So you add those guys back in. Now you can match up better defensively to Boston's length and kind of make it tough both ways. I think this has the potential to be a long and entertaining series. Boston definitely, I think, has a chance if they can get back to that level. We saw it was pretty kind of up and down in the Miami series, but they righted the ship enough to get the series taken care of.
I don't want to take anything away from the Warriors, but do you feel like the conversation around them is like, I don't think this is the team it was a few years ago. And I don't even know if it was the team that it was pre Durant. And I feel like it's kind of made out to be that way. Maybe there's some sort of inflation on how we feel about the Warriors because of what they've done over the last decade here. How do you feel about them right now compared to some of those teams over the last, 7-8 years?
Yeah, I think the big difference is Klay Thompson isn't what he was. I mean, he's just not even close to what he was defensively. He's still a good offensive player, but we saw him struggle for long stretches of the series. He's still able to get going in any given game, and we saw that throughout the playoffs, but he's not the 20-plus a game while locking you down on defense type of guy anymore. So it is definitely different in that way, because that really was the key. And you look at this Boston team, the key to those Golden State title teams, and they were so good offensively without really sacrificing anything on defense. Curry was kind of the one weak point on defense in the lineup. And again, he's a smart defender that is able to play his role well within a good defensive system. It's not even like he's Trae Young out there or anything. So, you had so many two-way players that could make an impact on both sides of the ball. And just most teams didn't have that. You had to make sacrifices on one side of the ball or the other and make those tough decisions. Do I go with the defensive guy? Do I go with an offensive guy? Meanwhile, Golden State had both. And so that's defensively, you got Boston that can match up there. Those guys just aren't as consistent offensively as we saw from those Golden State title teams. So while Klay isn't what he was, you still got, that combination of Klay, Curry, and Draymond Green, those guys have won a lot of basketball games together. And we see the way that Looney's performing in the postseason. Jordan Poole has obviously elevated himself to being a really, really good player, even in this setting. He gives up something defensively, but again, you put four great defenders around him, especially four great help defenders, and it limits that somewhat. So it definitely isn't the indestructible force that they seem to be before, whether it's with or without Durant, but it's still a really darn good team that has been here before. The core of the team has anyway. and knows how to get it done.
All right, Jacob. Appreciate the time as always. Looking forward to hopefully, like you said, a good finish to our basketball season through. And lucky for us, we have, you know, probably about 3 weeks left still, which is you know, both good and bad, I suppose. Talk to you later, Jacob. Thanks.
All right, sounds good.
Jacob Adil of Hill Varsity. I think Game 7 is supposed to be. I think the date for Game 7 would be on the 19th of June or something like
Father's
that.
Father's Day.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think
we got some time here.
Well, the thing that annoys me most is like tomorrow's game one, game two is Sunday.
Yeah. Now there's the 3 days in between, yeah. Except for in between three and four is just the one day.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah.
Terrible.
They drag it out a little bit.
A little bit. Yeah. June 19th would be game seven, Father's Day.
Just checking out
CWS doubleheader day.
The, UCLA and Texas just started off the Women's College World Series down in Oklahoma City.
Has Oklahoma won it yet?
They were doing some crowd shots, and Oklahoma's the heavy favorite, obviously, going into this tournament. I think they've only lost two games this entire year.
Yeah, they are 54-2.
Not bad. Not bad.
No.
Pretty good record.
That's pretty good.
Also, yeah. They're going to attempt to do this in front of a home crowd.
Yeah.
Which... That's not fun, really, for anybody else, whoever runs in Oklahoma during this Women's College World Series.
Yeah, do you want to, like, okay, should like, we take the trip out when, there? We made it. That's pretty incredible.
When our boys from Tennessee get here in a couple weeks, cross your fingers, they're going to bring the entire state of Tennessee with them, and the whole Chuck will be painted in orange. But the Oklahoma fans don't have to travel very far.
No.
For the women's culture. Let me look at it. They're showing a crowd shot right now. It's maroon.
Now, Texas has one of those two wins over Oklahoma.
And they're playing in this first game right now against UCLA.
The other team to do it is Oklahoma State.
Imagine that. Two losses on the season. They're both two pretty big rivals.
Yeah.
The softball and the women's college softball World Series is a great watch every year.
It is.
It's high quality stuff. Really good crowds. They put on a good show in Oklahoma City. I've long said this. Softball and volleyball are great TV products. It's fast. It's explosive. Mm-hmm. You know, and softball, and you'll see this maybe a time or two in the World Series, but they have a run roll too. They just, if you're up 10-0, see ya.
There's no need to drag.
No need to keep going. Anything like that.
Oklahoma plays at 2:30. Oklahoma State is in this tournament as well. They play at 9:30, the nightcap tonight.
Yeah.
I also like that somewhere along the way, somebody wised up and said, you know, we could put this on ABC and it'll work. Yeah. They got one Saturday game and one Sunday game on ABC.
Good old. I mean, it's all a national broadcast, but the, terrestrial, you can get it with your antennas for the three people who still have the antennas, I suppose.
And the thing you got to hook up to your antenna to get it to work still, or whatever that was a few years ago.
Just get cable, man. It's all good. You got it. You get it all in there. It's fantastic. Connor Happer for cable. Also here for the FanDuel Sportsbook, where the NBA Finals begin tonight, and throughout the NBA Finals, FanDuel is giving new customers $200. And free bets guaranteed. And all you have to do is place your first $5 bet. You could bet the game any way you like it. There's a million ways to do so on the FanDuel Sportsbook. I'm looking at one right now. How about this? And by the way, same game parlays. You know, you could do that here on the FanDuel Sportsbook. You could see that odds number go up and up and up. For example, Golden State's a 4-point favorite tonight in game one of the NBA Finals. I like Golden State in game one, by the way, even though I like Boston sort of for the series. If you did... In honor of the Uncut Gems thing, if you did Golden State -4, parlayed, same game parlayed with a Steph Curry first basket, plus 550, that gets you to plus 965 odds. That's $5 to almost win $50. You could do that on the FanDuel Sportsbook. And if you'd like to sign up, we encourage you to do so with promo code Happer. If you haven't tried FanDuel, it's the perfect time to give it a shot, because the only thing sweeter than watching the finals is cashing in on all the action. Join today. Promo code Happer, H-A-P-P-E-R. Turn a $5 bet into $200 in free bets, win or lose. But you're going to win this one.
Make every game feel like game seven with the FanDuel Sportsbook. 21 plus and present in Iowa. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable free bets that expires 14 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone.
Summer is here, and if you have a gotta-get-it-done-this-year project, trust the official exterior experts of the Huskers, JTech Construction. Call them for a free estimate on roofing, siding, windows, or even solar. They're close by with three locations in Nebraska, including Lincoln, Grand Island, and Omaha. Need financing? JTech offers 0% interest for 60 months. Call 402-261-3682 or go online to yourexteriorexperts.com. JTech Construction, Nebraska's exterior expert.
Hi, this is Kathy Kanoyer with Kanoyer Garden Center. The beauty and color of spring is in our greenhouse, featuring thousands of gorgeous hanging baskets and hundreds of varieties of Kanoyer-grown product. Come in and let our family help you find what you are looking for. Whether it's home decor, annuals, perennials, shrubs, tropicals, or vegetables, we have it all. Kanoyer Garden Center between Highway 370 and Cornhusker on 66th Street in Papillion. Open daily, 9 to 7.
At Kanoyer Garden Center, everybody's got a green thumb.
Spring is in the air. At Lanaha, we offer the area's most complete selection of landscape supplies and plant materials for all of your spring projects. Visit Lanaha's Garden Center today. Rooted in quality, unmatched value. 192nd and Center.
Prescription products require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if a prescription is appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information. Subscription required. Refund available for 60 days after purchase.
Having an issue with ED might begin in the bedroom, but it doesn't end there. It can also do a number on your confidence. But know this, you're not alone. 30 million guys deal with ED in the U.S. Fortunately, treating ED is now more straightforward and less awkward than ever, thanks to Hims. Through Hims, you can get the generic form of Viagra, which uses the same active ingredient for just $3 per use. Just go to 4hims.com and chat with a medical provider online. And if appropriate, you'll be prescribed the ED medication that's best for you. And it'll be shipped free to your door in discreet packaging. Simple. Plus, Hims gives you unlimited follow-up visits with medical providers. Get your confidence back at 4hims.com. Love your results or your money back.
To get started today, go to 4hims.com/radio. That's 4hims.com/radio for your free visit. forhims.com/radio.
Celebrate the college baseball championship with Screwball Peanut Butter Whiskey, the original peanut butter whiskey.
Your favorite teams are back, and Screwball is the perfect way to celebrate. A little sweet, a little salty, a little savory, and unlike anything you've ever tasted before. Screwball Peanut Butter Whiskey, available near you.
He was the heart of your family, and he taught you our history. He helped you fix your first flat. He was the best backyard DJ around, and every time he'd tell a story, he'd own the room. But now more than ever, he may feel alone. Today, older adults and their loved ones are struggling to connect in a time when connection has never been more important. But there is something we can do. Embrace our older loved ones through StoryCorps Connect. With StoryCorps Connect, you can honor seniors remotely with an interview about their life. Every interview will be archived at the Library of Congress, becoming part of American history, so that years from now, future generations can listen in.
All right, Grandpa, what's one piece of advice you have for me?
Just three words, sweetheart. Live with courage.
The man that had the best stories still has plenty of stories to tell. So connect virtually and share the conversation of a lifetime at StoryCorpsConnect.org/AARP. Connect, honor, share. StoryCorps Connect. A message from AARP, StoryCorps, and the Ad Council.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
And now we've reached the point in the show where Josh Odson reads the peculiar, the bizarre, the comical, the odd news with Odson. Odd news, Odson. See what we did there? The odd news with Odson.
Connor, we've just got word that someone wearing number 23 in Michael Jordan's old arena.
I can't believe that.
Won a huge game for Creighton.
Would you like to tell me more about that?
I think I've told you enough about that. I've told that story a lot, it seems. So I'm told.
At this point, it's just a bit. Mm-hmm. Actually, we're going to throw it in there more now.
Yeah.
I mean, to be, you may know, I definitely don't know how the stuff gets pulled to run on our app, because it's not the stuff that we're hearing over the air.
Yeah, it's not. We got better ads on the air.
But no matter how you listen, it's still AM radio. That was the news for, or that was the music for Odd News.
Yes.
Sam's coming up here in just a little bit, so we're going to flip it over and rush Josh and make him do the Odd News right now.
I can do it.
Thank God.
Okay, here we go. Pennsylvania is where we start today, where passengers on an amusement park ride were left upside down. They were stranded upside down during a mid-ride malfunction. Kennywood Park in West Mifflin confirmed the Aero 360 ride malfunctioned and left riders stranded upside down for a short time. Mm. It sounds like my own personal hell.
Yep.
Just
not where you want to be.
Yeah.
You don't want to be stuck on a roller coaster in general. Mm-hmm. You want that thing to be rolling as a coaster does, but you definitely don't want to be upside down. How long was this period of time?
It doesn't say. Now,
are you worried about the source here?
No, I just don't want to be, I can go upside down on the ride. That's fine.
Yeah. I mean, like
very quick, it's over.
It escalates pretty quickly. Anything more than about like 30 seconds, it starts getting very uncomfortable quickly if you're hanging upside down. Yeah. Also, if you're on a roller coaster, I mean, those things, they strap you in pretty good, but there's always a sense of feeling a little bit loose when, you know, especially when you're going around hard turns or when you're going upside down. Mm-hmm. I don't know. It's doesn't seem fun.
No, it doesn't.
I'm frankly amazed that we don't see more injuries on roller coasters.
Some say it was between 5 and 10 minutes.
That's a long time.
Yeah, it's just long enough to be like, I've been here a minute.
Have you ever ridden the road?
I think it's road.
Have you ever rode?
Road.
The
rude.
R-O-D-E. The wooden roller coaster at the Kansas City one, Worlds of Fun.
I believe it's
called the Timberwolf.
Yeah, it is. I rode it in my teens and at that
same
maybe early 20s, and I said, you know what,
not anymore.
My back can't handle
so
this.
That thing is shaking the whole time. It's insane. And then when they are about ready to put you back into the where you sort of start, you know, there's like canopy that kind of goes over the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And they tell you several times when the ride is slowing down, keep your arms in the damn roller coaster. But they don't convey the seriousness of it, really. They're just like, move your arms in. You're like, whatever. I've heard this a million times. It's like the instructions when you get on an airplane to buckle up your seatbelt. Yep. I was like,
literally no one is listening.
Yeah, like I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to buckle up the seatbelt and you don't have to teach me how to do it.
It's a seatbelt.
With that being said, I had my arms out one time and nearly got my left arm chopped off.
Oh, my goodness.
I don't know how close, but it couldn't have been more than a couple feet. I was like, whoa, they should probably just make that a little wider.
Yeah. I don't think
I'm surprised that doesn't happen more.
I think we should stop making wooden roller coasters. We should probably shut those down. I understand they're quaint. There's a history, there's a tradition involved.
Yeah.
And I'm not trying to get rid of that, but I am saying they're awful.
I have not been to Worlds of Fun or any theme park really in quite some time. I don't intend on going anytime soon. I assume technology has helped places like that, but I don't know.
We have major controversy in the Scripps National Spelling Bee yesterday.
Oh, no. Not famously on ION.
Yes, ION. Not on any political channels or sports channels anymore. It's now on ION. Don't worry, you haven't missed the finals. Those are tonight. Spoiler alert for what to watch on the final segment of the show today. A speller has been reinstated after successfully appealing that he was denied relevant root information about a word.
Oh!
You know, they always, can I have the origin. Country of origin?
Yeah.
Can you use it in a sentence?
And they told him no?
Well, let's find out. Now, before we get rolling in this story, I just want to say, I'm not a smart man, so I may mispronounce something. let's just cruise right on by it, okay? I'm not trying to be offensive. I'm just a dumb white guy, okay? Okay, got it? Here we go. 13-year-old from South Jordan, Syria Kapu from Utah. I'm sorry, South Jordan, Utah, not Jordan, the country. See, dumb white guy. Couldn't have written that better myself. Misspelled the word Lucovrin.
Sure.
Lucovrin. That is the correct spelling. A medicine used to counteract the side effects of a cancer drug during Wednesday's semifinal round, appearing to end his run just short of the finals. Syria, the family appealed, arguing that Scripps omitted details when he asked a question about the root words. Spellers are permitted to ask questions, as they often do. Judges answer in the affirmative if a speller can identify a relevant root and its meaning. Scripps said in a statement, its judges met for roughly 2 hours before deciding late last night to reinstate Syria.
Wow.
The judge's decision to reinstate is backed by a belief in the bee's mission to inspire the exploration of words and celebrate academic achievement.
Wow.
Sounds like it took him 2 hours to write a flowery statement.
Yeah.
Upon further review, it was determined that there was more directly relevant information available in the dictionary to one of the speller's questions. Based
on
this,
we're going to let this guy back in and then we're going to make a nice little public scene about it.
So at the beginning of tonight's finals, Syria will get a new word to begin spelling. If he spells that word correctly, he will join the 12 finalists who have already advanced to tonight's finals to compete for more than $50,000 in cash and prizes.
But of course, if he gets it wrong, this is all for nothing.
Yes, yes. No pressure, but you're sitting awake all night wondering if you're going to get back in. Okay, you're back in, and now you got to sit and wonder all day about your word.
I don't think I'll be watching this tonight, but I will look out for the video clip of the final word on Twitter.
Oh, yeah. Reinstatements are rare, but not unprecedented. The last one happened in 2018. When a competitor spelled a word's homonym correctly without having been given the definition or told that a homonym existed. So, like, you're obviously not this simple, but your word is there. And they spelled there. Oh, I'm sorry. We meant this other version.
The other version of the word.
Yeah. Big controversy in the spelling bee. This wouldn't have happened if it was still on ESPN where
people
could find it.
Wouldn't that come up in the definition?
They didn't ask for it.
Oh, they just went for it.
Yeah, I know that word.
So actually, this is a case where not asking questions help.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
And finally, Gary alluded to this in the crossover, but as your source for all things popcorn on the Connor Happer Show, there is a national shortage of popcorn that we unfortunately have to report to you this morning. Hollywood has been popping champagne corks over the success of Tom Cruise's Top Gun sequel, which raked in the most Memorial Day weekend box office ever. But there's a new problem looming. It has created a shortage of movie popcorn. Operators of movie theaters were reportedly nervous at the recent CinemaCon industry gathering about being able to stock their concession stands for the summer and holiday movie-going seasons, according to the Wall Street Journal.
Jeez.
Chief executive of Preferred Popcorn, a supplier of kernels to national theater chains, told the paper, quote, popcorn supply will be tight.
This is disappointing. How do they do how do they plan on
remedying this?
Yes.
It doesn't say. It says it has not affected most consumers.
I mean, usually once you figure out there is or will be a shortage, you sort of start to, you know, start to ration out a little bit.
I would imagine the rationing is beginning.
No, like, irresponsible popcorning.
Yeah. Hey, don't just, I understand you want to pop a whole bin full of popcorn and then just leave it there all day. We're not doing that. You're going to have to pop it every couple hours.
Boy, I hope this doesn't make the concession lines longer.
Oh, yeah, that would
because the 12-year-olds behind the counter are going to not be able to deal with this.
They are not. They will not know what to do. It also is affecting cups, trays for nachos and other necessities like your pretzel bites, what have you.
Oh, no.
Now, I went to the movies the other day and I got a generic white cup. It was like a big paper.
Like a styrofoam cup?
Not styrofoam, like white paper cup.
Okay.
I was like, okay, this is supposed to have like your theater chain's logo on it, or it's supposed to be a commemorative Jurassic World cup or something. It's just plain and white. This is new. Hmm. Turns out I might have just been a victim of the supply chain.
Maybe it was a paint your own cup.
That would have been neat. Just something to do during the Progressive commercials before the movie.
Do you know the Royals are doing that, I think, next weekend? So the Royals are doing not a cup. They have a 5,000. Don't quote me on this exactly, but 5,000 Nicky Lopez bobbleheads for the first 5,000 like adults into the stadium. The first 5,000 kids into the stadium get a blank Nicky Lopez bobblehead that you can paint it at whatever color you want.
Oh wow, that is neat.
Yeah, that's kind of cool. So that's making the most out of things. I don't know if there's a bobblehead shortage, but
well, it appears that there's lots of shortages, we didn't of anticipate.
Yeah, no doubt. Thank you, Josh.
Thank you.
That is the odd news. We have Sam McKewon of the Omaha World Herald. He will join the show next on 1620 The Zone.
Previously on Unsportsmanlike Conduct.
There's so many variables at stake here. What kind of a player are you getting? Scraps from those teams, legit frontline guys. I think in the case of Casey Thompson, you're getting a legit frontline guy. I mean, he did start the whole season.
Yeah. O'Shawn Mathis was an all-conference play.
O'Shawn Mathis is a legit top frontline guy.
Unsportsmanlike Conduct with John Bishop and Josh Peterson. Weekdays 2 to 6 on 1620 The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast presented by Funplex Water Park and Rides from the KETV Newswatch 7 Weather Center on 1620 The Zone.
Mostly sunny and warm for your Thursday with a high today in Omaha near 80 degrees with low humidity. Expect an afternoon breeze with westerly winds up to 20 miles an hour. Tonight, becoming partly cloudy, a tad cool with a low near 53 and light winds. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KETV Newswatch 7.
The Connor Happer Show returns in minutes on 1620 The Zone.
Accidents are stressful enough without having to navigate the claims process on your own. This is Darcy with Dingman's Collision Center. Don't be misinformed by others about your legal right to choose your shop. Having a certified repair facility working in your best interest is the only way to trust you've received the safe, proper repairs you deserve. Remember, it's your vehicle, your safety, and it's always your choice. Dingman's is your choice if you are looking for a certified shop that puts the vehicle owner first. At Dingman's, we would rather be the best than apologize for anything less. Dingmans.com.
Why are we experts in total pest control? Because what good is a beautiful lawn if bugs and pests keep you from going out and enjoying it? This is Chuck Monaco of CM's Outdoor, now part of the Ryan Lawn and Tree family. Our CM's and Ryan pros are known as the very best at getting rid of the nasty critters that enjoy chewing on your lawn, shrubs, and trees. So it only makes sense that we would also eliminate those annoying pests that see you as a tasty snack. Introducing Pest Guard Plus. We've combined our four most popular home pest control services into one year-round program. It includes keeping bugs out of your home, flea and tick control, mosquito, and rodent control. Pest Guard Plus keeps pests out of your home and out of your yard, so you can enjoy summer indoors and out. Visit bestomahalawn.com to learn more and receive a free estimate. Sign up now for Pest Guard Plus, and your first application is free. Enjoy a pest-free summer with Pest Guard Plus at bestomahalawn.com. That's bestomahalawn.com.
Heading to a cookout with family or friends? Heading home from a ballgame? Or heading no place in particular on a random weekday? All seems like great reasons to head over to Ted and Wally's Ultra Premium Ice Cream. Hey, it's Damon Benning from Sharp and Benning in the Morning. Ice cream on a hot summer day or night is awesome. And ice cream from Ted and Wally's is even awesomer. Yes, it's a word. You know me, I make them up, but not this time. Cones, cups, pints, quarts, even half gallons to go. Head to Ted and Wally's Ultra Premium Ice Cream. Celebrating more than 35 years, two locations, Benson and the Old Market. Visit TedandWally's.com.
Hi guys, it's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED, but what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improve drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now, 402-671-7777.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language. Like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
3 weeks. It's incredible. After 3 weeks, I'm on vacation in Paris, having a conversation in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
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 Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
You know, for Father's Day, there's just two things I want. I want to relax, and I want a good steak. Or a burger. I'm good with both. John Bishop here for Omaha Steaks. You know, Omaha Steaks and Father's Day, they go together pretty well. And right now, for just $99, you can treat your dad to some fillets, some franks, some chicken breasts, apple tartlets. Heck, if you use my promo code Bishop, we'll throw in 8 more Omaha Steak burgers. There's my burgers. That's what I want for Father's Day. So if my kids are listening right now, use my promo code Bishop when you go to omahasteaks.com. Yeah, I know they're going to end up using my money anyway, but at least it's going to be $99 and I'm going to save a lot and I'm going to enjoy some delicious Omaha Steaks. So use my promo code Bishop when you go to the search bar at omahasteaks.com and order the Dad's Want Steaks package and then relax because it's Father's Day. Use my promo code Bishop in the search bar, omahasteaks.com. Happy Father's Day.
Equitable Bank. We take banking personally. EquitableOnline.com.
Sam McKewon of the Omaha World Herald will join us in a minute or two here. So ESPN today, we'll talk about this on our own a little bit in the noon hour as well. They tiered out have I told you how much I enjoy tears? Not like actual physical tears, but tearing things. They tiered out every quarterback situation in the country. There's 25 tiers.
Wow.
Of quarterbacks across the country.
That's a lot.
Football. It is. There's your Heisman or bust guys at the top. CJ Stroud, Caleb Williams, Bryce Young. There's a group of really good quarterbacks, proven guys, stepping into good situations. And you go down the list a little bit and you find tier 7. And that's where Kansas State's Adrian Martinez pops up. And then you have to scroll a little bit further to find how they phrased it for Nebraska's. And once again, this is a tier of quarterback situations, not quarterbacks, but quarterback situations. Tier 14 is where you find Nebraska's situation with Casey Thompson and Logan Smothers and Chubba Purdy. Now, I don't know that Logan Smothers is as involved in the starting gig here as maybe ESPN wants it to seem like. I wouldn't put totally to bed the idea that Chubba could make this a little tricky on Casey Thompson, but I would still expect Casey Thompson to be the starter at this point. They're in tier 14. And this has been the talking point of the week for whatever. I guess I know what reason. Adrian Martinez talked about some things on a podcast and it opened up the whole offense and quarterback question. And it leads me to this, which I'll ask to Sam. What is the quarterback's role? What will the quarterback's role be in Nebraska's quote unquote new offense? Will it be different than it was under Adrian Martinez, with Adrian Martinez, because of a new coaching staff and all that stuff? Will it be the same? And what's the effect that that has on the players involved? And now we welcome in Sam McKewon of the Omaha World Herald. Hello, Sam.
Hey, hey. What's going on? Thanks for being patient with me. I was finishing up a podcast.
Oh, yeah. No problem. No problem. So we were talking, there's been a lot of quarterback talk this week. Adrian Martinez has talked a couple times, really over the last couple months. But so this is back into the forefront. There was a quarterback tier list today that ESPN put out. And ultimately, I think at Nebraska, it comes down to, you know, a few things. But a big question for me is, what is the role of the quarterback in Nebraska's offense and Nebraska's new, well, Nebraska's offense under a new coaching staff?
So what was the quarterback tier list? I haven't seen it yet. I've been busy all morning.
So they had Adrian at in tier set. They had like 25 tiers.
Oh God.
Yeah. It's a lot. Tier seven, they called Adrian's. You might not have noticed, but they're pretty good. And then tier 14 is where you could find, and they did situations. So it's like Casey Thompson, Smothers, and Purdy. But it said in tier 14, which is where Nebraska's situation shows up, is there a diamond in the rough, basically? Like kind of a, I don't know, like a hope and a prayer type of thing. That's kind of the sort of idea that I got. I don't know if that's totally accurate for Nebraska's situation, because we know Nebraska's is a little bit different. But I go back to the question. What is the role of the quarterback for 2022 Nebraska?
What is the quarterback situation? Is that essentially what you're saying?
No, what is the role of the quarterback? What do they need the quarterback to be able to do?
Okay, so there's a variable here, and the variable is, can Nebraska hand the ball off and run the football without having used quarterback?
Right.
And that is a variable that is not easily controlled by the quarterback. And so can Anthony Grant, Jock Ant, Ramir Johnson, and a fourth running back, Gabe Irvin or AJ Allen, can they get the job done without having to require the quarterback to get overly involved? Since Scott Frost has arrived, and quite frankly, in 2017 as well, Mike Riley's last year, the answer was no, they cannot. And so when Mike Riley was here, it didn't matter because Tanner Lee was like, you know, had the speed of a yak. But when Adrian Martinez got here, it was like, oh, it's great. I mean, we've got this guy who can do all the running for us. And so we don't have to worry as much about just handing the ball off. And, you know, and that always, it feels good. It's like, it's good yards. It looks good on paper. A lot of Adrian Martinez's stats are racked up that way. It helps with the play action passing. That's why people think, well, Adrian is better than you think because he has all these rushing yards. The problem with you doing that is that it creates turnovers and it beats the crap out of your quarterback so that by the end of the year, they're not playing.
Uh-huh.
They're not playing very well. Uh-huh. And so what I would say is Nebraska's role at quarterback is impartially defined or shaped by whether Nebraska can hand the stinking ball off and gain 4 or 5 yards of carry. If they can do that, then the quarterback's role is going to be to stay in the pocket, to get rid of the dang ball, throw to open receivers, and try to throw them open, you know, hit them in stride, and just work the offense. And that might mean you throw for 212 yards a game.
Yep.
And you throw 20 touchdowns and 12 interceptions. If they cannot run the football with just handing it off to a running back, then the quarterback's role will once again be to be a hero and run it 14 times a game and try not to fumble. And you're probably going to see some Logan Smothers and Chubba Purdy, because I don't know that Casey Thompson is really the guy for that.
No,
I know that he ran last year. He did, but I just don't think that's the overall, you know, vision for the operation.
Chubba seems to be a little better. Chubba seems to be a little better off script, at least from the very brief, you know, image of what we saw in the spring game.
Right. I think that's fair. So let's see here. Casey Thompson ran the ball 55 times. in 2021. I'm guessing about half of those were sacks. So he ran it really about 28 times in 12 games. So 55 divided by 12, let's do some math, is about 4.2 carries a game. So he's not the guy that does that. Adrian Martinez, on the other hand, I think we all know how often he ran the ball. He ran it 133 times in 11 games. And so a completely different football player there. And ran for 13 touchdowns. He was their red zone running back.
Oh, yeah.
Adrian Martinez. He was their red zone running back. That's what he did. And so the question becomes, can Donovan Raiola, get that figured out? That's one of the biggest questions is, can Donovan Raiola, help this offensive line block in a way so that your quarterback's not running the ball 12 times a game like Adrian was? So Adrian ran it three times more per game than Casey Thompson. And by three times, I don't mean three more carries. I mean
three right multiplied. Yeah.
And that's the wear and tear, man. That's why Adrian Martinez, when you look at his passing numbers, he threw 14 touchdowns and Casey threw 24. It's a huge dynamic change. And that's the area where, they got to get better, Connor. They just got to get better is at just running the football without having to ask that quarterback to do it.
My thing with the, I've been talking about this for a long time. I know you have too. It's absolutely true. They need to get better at traditionally running the ball. For me, and we've seen like spurts of this over Adrian Martinez's tenure where they'll get a running back going and they'll have a big day. And it's hard to sort of figure out why they did it that day. Was it because of the opponent, because of a weakness that they saw? So what I go back to, and yes, they have to be able to do it. They have to be able to be good on the offensive line and find a way to have a good running game. But more so for me, the question is, will they? It's more of like a choice thing than it is anything else. Do you see it that way?
Well, it's an interesting frame. We're used to the word choice.
Yeah.
You're not as far off as some people may say, because there is something to be said for, okay, you can't do it, and so you have to use the quarterback to run the ball because, gosh darn it, you're going to run the football. But then you have Iowa, and Iowa chooses to run the football quite a bit, as most people know, but they do not run it with their quarterback. They just don't. They refuse. And Iowa averaged 123 yards rushing per game last year. They averaged 36 carries, and almost all of those were carries by running back. I mean, just almost all of them were. Nebraska averaged 40 yards per carry, and they averaged 180 rushing yards per game. 40 carries per game, I should say.
Yeah.
But, I would say that 40% of their carries were from quarterback.
Yeah, I have that stat somewhere, yeah.
Yeah, Iowa just doesn't do it. They won't do it. They will not jeopardize their quarterback that way. And you can look at it a bunch of different ways. And there's arguments to be made.
Sam, last year, by the way, 35% of Nebraska's carries came from quarterbacks.
Okay.
And it was
I'm guessing Iowa was somewhere around 4.
Just for reference, in 2020 it was 48 because that was the Luke McCaffrey year. In 2019, it was 37, almost 38%. And in 18, it was right around where it was last year, 35.
Yeah. And that tells you, that tells you a lot. Minnesota's another one, Tanner Morgan. So Minnesota had 46 carries per game last year, which is a lot. And they ran the ball a ton. And, they have what they do, Minnesota has a Wildcat quarterback named Cole Kramer. And that's all he did is come in and run. And he did that 4.5 times per game. But Tanner Morgan, he ran 4.5 times per game, and most of those were sacks. And so, Minnesota's another one that did not jeopardize their quarterback by doing what they do. So some of it's a choice and some of it is. But back to the what is the role of the quarterback? Well, look, if you're gonna insert your quarterback into the run game, then they got to be the hero. They've got to be incredible. And we've seen a lot of great quarterbacks do that. Kyler Murray was great in college. Lamar Jackson was great in college. There's just a lot of great quarterbacks who have done that. Ohio State used to be that way with JT Barrett. And then when Ryan Day took over, they stopped doing that. So Dwayne Haskins, the late Dwayne Haskins, didn't really do that.
Yep.
Fields kind of did a little bit more. But CJ Stroud doesn't really do that much because they know that they're going to get those quarterbacks beaten up.
Only in games when they really need to.
That's right. So we've moved in 15 years. It's been 15 years since Tim Tebow won the Heisman Trophy. And those 15 years, we've moved away from the Tim Tebow model of winning football titles. That was kind of what you did back then. Is you Tebowed it up.
Make the quarterback the center of the universe.
Yeah, and it worked with Tebow. I mean, uh-huh. He was almost indestructible. And then you had you had the Oregon model, and Oregon ran their quarterbacks a lot too, with Jeremiah Masoli and Dennis Dixon, and then you had Cam Newton, and Cam Newton was the exact same way. He was like a tank. You couldn't stop him. But we've moved away from that model now. The national title winning quarterback is a guy by the name of Stetson Bennett IV. And he's not Cam Newton. He's nowhere near as good as Cam Newton was.
No, not
and
quite.
His job's not to run the football. Right. Cam Newton ran the ball 264 times when Auburn won the national championship. 264. That is 18 carries of football.
Yeah, I don't think that's a good method for anybody else not named Cam Newton.
And Denard Robinson ran it about 20 times a game.
Yeah.
So again, in the span of 15 years, we've moved away from the Rich Rod and the Gus Malzahn. We've moved away from that model. It's no longer the model. Now the model is, it doesn't matter how tall your quarterback is. Bryce Young is, they say he's 6 foot. I don't know what he is. Doesn't matter. Go out and get four fast receivers and two elite tackles, put that guy in the shotgun, and let him deal. And that's all he's going to do. He's going to throw it 40 times a game. He's going to throw it for 500 yards if he can. The Joe Burrow, Bryce Young, model of playing football. And so we've changed. And to be very honest with you, Nebraska's probably going to do more of that than they're going to do of the tank set where it's, it's Taylor Martinez getting the crap beat now. And Taylor Martinez was one of the toughest players that Nebraska's ever had. And I know that he had a weird senior year with his broken foot. And I've seen the MRIs of that foot, and it was hideous.
Yeah, gross.
But before that, Taylor was really tough, and he did not miss games very often. And, some of that is he was able to kind of bear up under it, but Nebraska fell apart each year because they didn't have a quarterback at the end of the season. And unfortunately, under Scott Frost, that was pretty much true of Adrian Martinez, except for 1 year. In 2018, he was healthy at the end of the year. In 2019, he was banged up. In 2020, at the end of that year, he was banged up. And then in 2021, he didn't even play the last game because he broke his shoulder. So, they're going to have to figure it out. If you use your quarterback, you're taking all the risks that I just went.
Yeah. And the reason why the can and the will thing comes up, because I've dove into this from a statistical standpoint. Those numbers came up because I have them, the 35% quarterback, carry share, whatever. And that's a pretty high number anyway. They got to find a way to get that down, but that's about as low as they've been over their 4 years. In individual games, Sam, in which they stay below that the quarterback is less important, their winning percentage skyrockets. They went winless in games where the quarterback had more than 35% of the carries in an individual game last year. They were 0-5. It's
right.
I feel like you have to really commit to it. Say it again.
Some of that's corollary. I mean,
no doubt.
They don't
want
to have to. If they can hand the ball off to Jack Legiant against Northwestern and he can just run unabated for 40 yards, then all the better. So there's a corollary relationship there, just like there's a corollary relationship to explosive plays. But, go back and watch the first, this is going to sound so strange, Go back and watch the first quarter and a half of that Illinois game. And they tried really hard not to run the quarterback for about a quarter and a half.
Yep.
And then Adrian fumbled. He got sacked. He shouldn't have been sacked, and he should have gotten rid of the ball, but he didn't. He fumbled. Illinois returned that for a touchdown, and it was like, screw it. We're back to where we always
it's
were.
It's crazy.
Adrian scrambling around.
There have been games. There have been a handful, at least, of games over the last 4 years where they've sort of like, oh, okay, this is kind of what it's, you know, this is what you want it to be. And then one thing happens and it totally reverts.
Well, they were down 39, you know, and we better go back to what we can do, which is Adrian running around. So, you know, part of the problem is you've got to be good at it. And then if you're not good at it, you have to spend the labor and the capital to get better at it, even if it doesn't work right away. And so, you know, I think the challenge that Nebraska's had all along under Frost is that, you know, they have not consistently built the identity that is needed on the offensive side of the ball. They make too many mistakes and they blow up too many drives. The defense has been the opposite. The defense has learned over the course of 4 years what you can and can't do. And Chenander's gotten really good at calling defenses. You go back to 2018 and they're running these seven-man, you know, casino blitzes that don't get home.
Yep.
Lose to Northwestern because they can't cover, you know, Flynn Nagel in the slot because there's zero coverage. And they stopped doing that. So they've learned. You can do that stuff in the AAC when the interior guard is 263 pounds and perhaps doesn't know how to do that.
Yeah.
In the Big Ten, that's harder to do. So, you know, I think they've learned along the way, and they're better on defense. And then
you're going to sacrifice some explosiveness to, you know, hang on to the ball and not turn it over, and B, you know, put together some consistent drives. That's a great trade.
You know, I don't know that. I would just encourage your listeners to really sit down and marinate and think about how much the sport has changed since Tim Tebow won his Heisman. Because everybody thought the game was going to change forever with Rich Rodriguez and Tim Tebow and Cam Newton, and everybody thought, oh, this is it. This is and it's going to tilt back Nebraska's way because it's basically a newfangled triple option, and Urban Meyer is just doing what T.O. used to do, only he's doing it out of the shotgun. And look at how quickly defenses have adjusted.
It's steered more back toward the Big Ten.
No question. Well, it's steered more to, you know, I think everybody's like Joe Burrow and the four NFL receivers. That's what everybody wants now. Now, you know, LSU was unique in that they had those elite receivers, and that helped. But, like, if you can get a quarterback who can spin it out of the shotgun and throw it 35, 40 times a game, that's the answer. And then I think
connect on some jump balls.
The NFL has changed that too. You know, he's made it easier. Everybody watches Patrick Mahomes and they're like, you don't need to run the football. You can just have Patrick Mahomes. Now that's probably gonna fall away too. But I do feel like the sport has changed and that, you know, the single wing quarterback is no longer the thing that it used to be.
Yeah. Well, I know Nebraska's offensive coordinator knows that. And then that's where you get into sort of the, you know, the setup and the power dynamic, I guess, if you will, between the two main guys that are making the decisions for the offense and what it might look like this year.
You cut out there real quick. Can you repeat that?
That's where you sort of, because I know that the offensive coordinator knows, you know, that the game is sort of changing. His offenses over the last couple of years have looked a lot like that, and he had a good quarterback. Then there's the power dynamic, because, you know, who's making the call on what they're going to look like this year. Is the head guy, or is it Mark Whipple?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, Scott Frost is the head coach and obviously wants things to go well for him. Everybody's, you know, things need to go well for Nebraska to win games. If any of those guys are probably going to keep their jobs. So I would anticipate Scott having, you know, pretty strong veto power there. Again, you do what you got to do to win some games. If you need to win six or seven, you do what you got to do. What I would say is that they have a quarterback on their roster who can do a lot of those things for them, and they don't need to have him being the quarterback who throws the football, and they need to find ways to get Logan Smothers into the game.
Yeah.
And he still had, he still retains the ability to throw the football, but you've got to find ways to get a running quarterback on the field who's good at that and isn't also being, you know, taxed the way that Thompson would be for an entire game throwing the football. And I don't know what they're going to do. Like, you know, they're going to have to figure out how they want to do it. Maybe it'll be easy. Maybe they'll just be able to throw the, run the football right downhill and just be a downhill running team. I know Scott's wanted that, and he has not felt like they've been able to do that. And I think for that reason, there's been a push, a really hard push, to try to get a different kind of dynamic when you're running the football. And I think that's what they're hoping Donovan Rayl will give them.
Yeah. Sam, good chat as always. We will talk to you soon.
All right. Take care.
That's Sam McKewon from the Omaha World Herald.
Mystery co-host on his pod now.
Oh yeah. Is he rocking the silhouette?
Yeah, yep. Nice. Silhouette with a question mark.
Nice. Should have asked. Bad job by me.
Well, you don't. He's not going to give you that information.
Well, he could tease it. Yeah, I'd give him the opportunity to tease it.
Maybe a clue.
Yeah. The Sam showdown with somebody else.
Bum, bum, bum.
All right, this week's zone deal is for Frank's. Frank's Pizza. Omaha's home for true New York pizza, calzone, stromboli, pasta, sandwiches, salads, desserts. Family owned and operated for 15 years. And now in Omaha with two locations, you can get 50% off an Omaha favorite, Frank's Pizzeria, for this week's discount deal. $40 worth of gift vouchers for just $20 on sale. And the zone deals go very fast. So get right on it. June 3rd, Friday, 9 a.m., 1620thezone.com.
Now live on Twitch, YouTube, and 1620thezone.com.
At Woodhouse, we make car buying simple. From test drive to purchase, we're here to help guide you to your next vehicle with no pressure sales, transparent pricing, and a streamlined purchase process to save you time. Finding the place to shop for your next vehicle just got easier. Whether you're looking for a car, truck, or SUV, we will get you on the road faster with a vehicle that exceeds your expectations. Find new roads and explore all our inventory arriving daily at WoodhouseGM.com and at our dealership in Missouri Valley, Iowa.
Okay, team, it's summer. Your training all comes down to this. Checklist. Emma, sunscreen, set. Alex, shades,
yep, set.
Baby Zoe, diaper bag, we're just gonna call that a yes. Are you ready for fun flex?
Check. Roll out to the minivan.
But we can't drive. Let's find Mom and then go to the minivan.
Yay! It's all for fun and fun for all at Funplex. 70th and Q, dude. Get your tickets now at fun-plex.com.
Howdy, folks. Greg Wagner joining you from the Nebraska Game and Parks Commission. And time now for another Nebraska Outdoor Update. Hey, grab your gear and take them fishing. What do you say? Take a newcomer out fishing. Share a pic with us at Game and Parks Online, and then become eligible to win some very cool prizes. Everything from a state park cabin stay to a nice kayak. It's our Take 'em Fishing Challenge. See more about that on the Game and Parks website, outdoornebraska.org. That's outdoornebraska.org. And we have some angler reminders to pass along as well, that any of you going fishing 16 years of age or older must have a current Nebraska fishing permit signed and on your person. And you need to learn the limits for the fish you're after, where you're fishing, daily bag, possession, and length. It's all part of knowing before going. I wish you the best out there fishing. I'm Greg Wagner with Nebraska Game and Parks.
We put our lives on the line for our country. We braved the unknown. We did what we were told, and we lit up. Our cigarette packs were as valuable as the packs on our back, maybe more. At one point, cigarettes were part of our daily ration. Smoke 'em if you got 'em. And boy, we were smoking 'em. Bumming a smoke was the norm. It was an escape from the reality of dirt, sweat, and forgetting how many days you were so far from home. Never had to worry so long as you had a light and the smoking lamp was lit. If that was you then, get your lungs screened now
Surviving lung cancer starts with a scan. Learn more at screenyourlungs.org. And thank you for your service. This PSA was made possible by industry funding and guidance from lung cancer patient groups.
DQ presents the sound of an all-star summer lineup. Leading off, the promising rookie, new Oreo Dirt Pie. On deck, the fan favorite Girl Scout Thin Mints. Summer standouts, drumstick with peanuts and cotton candy. And batting cleanup, it's you. With your red spoon and six summer blizzard flavors, official treat of MLB, all part of the new DQ All-Star Summer Blizzard lineup. DQ, happy tastes good.
Every once in a while, there's a tendency breaker. And teams or players, guys, will do something that we don't expect. Wow, that's not like him. That's not very on brand. It's not very on brand for this team. Could be some pleasant surprises. Could be like, well, I expected only consistency from this. Well, that was not the case with Mike Trout yesterday. As we predicted on the show, Mike was peppered with questions from the New York media about his involvement in the now infamous Major League Fantasy Football Baseball League. The Tommy Pham and Jock Peterson, Eric Hosmer, Mike Moustakas $10,000 buy-in Fantasy Football League that was commissioned by Mike Trout. Coincidentally, as this is all unfolding, they go and play the Yankees, and Mike Trout does a media session with the New York media. And, you know, there would have been questions to ask anyway. New York media only gets one crack at him. But the hot topic yesterday was fantasy football. Did Mike Trout throw a curveball yesterday and do something that we didn't expect from him? No. No, he did not. Here he is.
I ain't talking about fantasy football. I don't even know. You know, it's just one of them things. It's, you know, everybody's competitive. Just, everybody loves fantasy football. Who doesn't? So.
Have you been caught off guard with this, like, a week-long story and all
that? I think it's you guys dragging it on. you know, I talked to Tommy. I talked to Jock. You know, everybody in that was part of it. You know, we're just passionate about fantasy football. So.
You still going to resign?
What's that? Am I going to resign? I haven't made that decision. I don't know. Every commissioner I know always gets booed. So. No, but it's like I said, you know, Tommy and everybody in that was involved in that. You know, very passionate about fantasy football. I think a lot of people, you know, put their hearts to it. I do too. I lost that league, so.
Did Jack break the rules? Now you're the commissioner, so do the last word.
I'm not answering that question. You know, it's in the past. Like I said, you guys are dragging it on, but it's a legendary fantasy football league for sure.
I mean, like, I understand, like, it's kind of embarrassing, but it's also, like, somewhat funny. There's just in-depth discussion of the fantasy.
Like, I got suspended over it, like,
I got great.
Move on, guys.
Yeah.
All right. So that there at the end, if you heard it, it's a little bit of a grainy video.
Yeah.
That there at the end, after New York media was going to continue to ask him about this and continue to make Mike Trout extremely uncomfortable. He's sort of like moving around, fidgeting. I'm not talking about fantasy football. You guys keep dragging it on. Like, that's about as aggressive as you're going to get from Mike Trout. You guys are making this a story. He said it in sort of a joking way, but then he said it twice.
Strongest stance I've ever heard from him.
And the guy that you heard there at the end was the Angels media guy saying, all right, move on. It's time to move on. Because he could see Trout is getting uncomfortable. And I'd like to say this. Boo Mike Trout. This was your chance. This was your chance to have any semblance of personality.
Could have said anything. Nobody would have cared.
Frankly, exactly. It was so low stakes.
Yeah.
It was so low stakes. I'll get to that in a second. But... From frankly, it's a surprise to me that Mike Trout was involved in this league in the first place. Certainly surprising to me that he's the commissioner of this fantasy.
Well, it
sounds
like that was forced upon him. It sounded like nobody wanted it.
Yeah.
And somehow he became
like Mike Trout does not strike me as the guy who's spending 10 grand to enter into a fantasy football league. He strikes me as somebody who's a sensible spender. He's not hanging out with the rest of the San Diego Padres and you know, blowing money on a cool fantasy football draft party. Mike Trout doesn't care for that stuff. And I guess credit him for staying true to himself. But this was your chance. You could have said anything. You could have dropped a nugget or two about the fantasy football league, given us some more details. Nobody's actually going to be mad at you if you throw someone under the bus here, because this story is a joke. It doesn't mean anything. It's hilarious. So throw Tommy Pham under the bus.
Everyone else has. And apparently, he doesn't have a lot of friends in this league.
They asked him specifically if Jock broke the rules. I'm not going to comment on that. He knows. He knows just like everybody else in the league knows. This was Mike. I'm sort of kidding, but I'm not kidding. This was Mike Trout's actual opportunity to... Like, I think if he says something funny here, or, you know, I don't know, like it gives you a little window into him having some sort of a personality at all, like that could be a big win for Mike Trout's career. And he obviously doesn't want to be that guy.
Yeah, or he would have. If he goes out in this presser and says something...
He just goes scorched earth on somebody.
Even slightly comical, just a little rib towards Tommy Pham, he could charge $500 on Cameo and be like, I'll be the commissioner of your fantasy football league, and I'll talk smack to your fantasy football commissioner.
It'd be a great bit at the very least.
Mm-hmm.
And Mike Trout's like, no, I'm shutting this whole thing down. You media people are just dragging on the story. And nobody's dragging it on because nobody thinks it's actually serious. It's funny. And we like distractions from the real world. So we are attracted to stories that are funny and stupid. At least I am. I don't know about anybody else. That's what we've been talking about for the last 3 days on this show. This story is incredibly stupid. That's why I love it. Nobody actually cares whether Jock Peterson or Tommy Pham broke any rules. I just think it's hilarious that it came to him slapping him and taking a 3-game suspension from his employer.
2 years later.
2 years later. Off a waiver claim.
I love learning that the entire league hates Tommy Pham. Didn't know that until this weekend. I love $10,000 buy-in. Ooh, who's playing high stakes fantasy football?
Turns out it's Eric Hosmer and the rest of the Padres.
Mm-hmm.
This is now the fantasy league that everyone wants to know about. And Mike Trout just refuses. He is a huge wet blanket. I now hate Mike Trout.
Ooh.
No. I don't. I love the way he plays. I love watching him play baseball. It's a lot of fun. I've always liked the way he plays baseball.
Well, let me bounce this off of you.
It's disappointing. He's just such a wet blanket.
Amazing Daniel tweets in. Maybe Trout doesn't want to get in a physical fight with a crazy person, so he decided not to fuel it.
He's scared of getting slapped by the slap monster.
Look at Mike Trout.
You think
he's jacked?
You think Pham's going to go around and slap some more people? He just took a 3-game suspension.
A second offense would be a lot longer.
I think it'd be a 10-gamer if he were to slap Mike Trout. The money part of it's over. Like, this story is hilarious. And Mike Trout was just like, yeah, okay, you guys got your kicks now. Time to kill this. Time to squash this story. Boo, Mike Trout.
Anybody want to talk about Shohei?
Boo, Mike Trout.
Yeah.
This was your chance.
Missed opportunity.
This was your chance to have a personality, and you didn't take it.
You could have been on Fox talking fantasy football on the pregame shows.
Yep. Yep.
Like, you could have carved out a niche for yourself here.
And guess what? Now I'm forced to mention every time we talk about Mike Trout on this show that he's only been to the playoffs once, and he got swept by the Kansas City Royals in 2014.
You cannot be the greatest player of a generation if you've never won a playoff game.
You either have to be funny and entertaining for us, or win.
You're neither.
You're neither.
Neither.
Mike Trout.
Overrated. I said it.
Hold on. He's really, really good.
He's really good. Not even the best player on his own team, Connor. Does he pitch?
He's still the best player on his own team, I think.
Does he pitch?
He does not pitch.
There you go. Answer the question, Connor.
I always think it's weird that Mike Trout, like, Mike Trout is like a, he sort of looks like a gym bro.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, he should have gone full New Jersey frat dude and, like, made a joke out of this entire thing.
Yeah, he's from that area, right?
Yeah, he's Jersey.
Jersey.
He's an Eagles guy.
That's right. I knew I had seen him at a I-95 football game.
Yeah, he shows up at an Eagles game. People are like, Mike Trout's here. I'm like, well, nobody really cares about Mike Trout. He's the best player of our generation. One of the best players of all time already. 10 years into his career.
Overrated.
And he could be the biggest star on the planet if he wanted to. But he doesn't want to. And I guess to a certain extent, I respect it. But I just say something. One time. That's all.
You didn't do this to play baseball, Mike. you did this for chicks. You
frankly,
did this for money.
It takes effort for him to say as little as he has over the last decade.
I do agree with that. Like, it takes effort to be as boring as Mike Trout.
It's very careful. He's never had a controversial take about anything. And he's, look, I mean, he hasn't gone to the playoffs except for the one time. He catches flack for that, but he gets to hide because he's on the West Coast. Mm-hmm. He had a teammate of his pass away, and like he didn't, you know, there wasn't, and it was in a very controversial way. He didn't say anything about that. Mm-hmm. Somehow stayed away from that, where usually you go to that guy because he's sort of the representative for baseball.
Yep.
And he's certainly the representative for the Angels.
No one's ever come up to him and said,
like, he's had a sort of event. He's had an eventful career.
Yeah. Hey, there's a lot of racism around Shohei Ohtani. Like, what do you think about that?
Right.
No one's ever asked him that.
He finds a way out of these conversations. He actively avoids them.
I think he was in a Subway commercial.
He was definitely in a Subway commercial. Okay. He's done some Subway stuff. Which I don't know how Subway's pulling Mike Trout and Bill Belichick.
What's their pitch?
Is it, hey, we're really boring? Come hang out with us?
You know, it might be. You're perfect for our brand because we're inoffensive just like you. Except for that one guy we hired that was offensive. But we didn't know.
We're going to come back. More up next here on 1620 The Zone. There is a retirement in a very... Speaking of being on brand... We have a retirement in a very on-brand way.
We do.
In the NFL, that up next here on 1620 The Zone.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone.
Home is where your health is, where your family gathers together, takes care of each other. And right there with you is Nebraska Medicine. We're proud to take care of Nebraska to deliver everything your family needs. From immediate care to neurosurgery, it's expertise you can be confident in. With locations throughout the region and telehealth appointments from the comfort of home. Find a provider close to you at NebraskaMed.com.
Home is with you wherever that may be.
CM's Outdoor, now a proud part of Ryan Lawn and Tree. For a limited time, get your first lawn or pest application for free. Schedule a free estimate at BestOmahaLawn.com. That's bestomahalawn.com.
At Woodhouse, we make car buying simple. From test drive to purchase, we're here to help guide you to your next vehicle. With no pressure sales, transparent pricing, and a streamlined purchase process to save you time, finding the place to shop for your next vehicle just got easier. Whether you're looking for a car, truck, or SUV, we will get you on the road faster with a vehicle that exceeds your expectations. Find new roads and explore all our inventory arriving daily at WoodhouseGM.com. And at our dealership in Missouri Valley, Iowa.
your stomach's doing that I'm hungry thing. But you don't want a burger joint breakfast, and you don't have time for a sit-down place. You want a quality breakfast to go brunch fast. Good thing there's Hurry Bird. Hurry Bird serves up your favorite breakfast and lunch foods fast. From breakfast burritos and avo toast to chicken sandies and grilled cheese to help get you to where you're going. Hurry Bird. Next to Early Bird at 38th and Farnham in the Blackstone District. Open every day from 6:30 to 2:30.
Prescription products require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if a prescription is appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information. Subscription required. Refund available for 60 days after purchase.
Having an issue with ED might begin in the bedroom, but it doesn't end there. It can also do a number on your confidence. But know this, you're not alone. 30 million guys deal with ED in the U.S. Fortunately, treating ED is now more straightforward and less awkward than ever, thanks to Hims. Through Hims, you can get the generic form of Viagra, which uses the same active ingredient for just $3 per use. Just go to 4hims.com and chat with a medical provider online, and if appropriate, you'll be prescribed the ED medication that's best for you. And it'll be shipped free to your door in discreet packaging. Simple. Plus, Hims gives you unlimited follow-up visits with medical providers. Get your confidence back at 4hims.com. Love your results or your money back. To get started today, go to forhims.com/radio. That's forhims.com/radio for your free visit. forhims.com/radio.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles. KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
Finally, the day has come for Ryan Fitzpatrick, who's retiring from the NFL after 17 years.
Nine teams.
Now, speaking of a character, this is a guy who's nowhere near the skill level of Mike Trout, but I'd argue that he's a bigger star. I don't know. He's about on the, I think that's a pretty comparable level of stardom. Mike Trout versus Ryan Fitzpatrick. Obviously, they have a completely different talent level. Not to take away too much from Fitzmagic, who was awesome to watch. But he sent a, what it looks like to me. It's sort of confusing. Schefter tweeted it out. It is one of those word sort of like, I don't know what you would call it.
It's a word cloud.
Word cloud. Thank you, Josh. And it appears to be all of the people that Ryan Fitzpatrick was ever on a team with, and then the names of those people get bigger based on the amount of games that he has played with them on the same team as. The biggest names that I see on here are Fred Jackson, Nick Mangold, let's see, Devontae Parker, Carson Palmer, Brandon Marshall, Ali Marpet. Like, this is just totally stupid, but hilarious and very Ryan Fitzpatrick. Are you looking up how many games anybody has played? Oh, no, you're doing something.
No, I was posting some podcasts.
You were furiously typing.
Yeah. A lot of tags on these pods.
Schefter tweets after. Playing for nine teams over 17 NFL seasons, Ryan Fitzpatrick has told his former teammates in an incredible text that he sent to them that he is retiring. Here is a copy of that text from Fred Jackson. And it seems to be a word cloud of all the people that he ever played on an NFL team with.
So he played for nine teams, the last being Washington. He played the opening week. And then in between weeks one and two, the story goes that he went to a water park with his family. And while going down a water slide, injured his hip. He did not play the rest of the season and is now retiring So allegedly, a water slide ended the career of Ryan Fitzpatrick.
We were just talking about the dangers of roller coasters earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Watch out for those roller coasters and water parks. Man.
Just what an image Ryan Fitzpatrick is with the open shirt and the beard.
I don't think Fitzmagic would rather go out anyway, though.
Yeah, it's oddly on brand.
The other way. I would have liked to see Ryan Fitzpatrick in the match last night.
I would like to have seen anybody interesting in the match last night.
Thank you.
I think that
idea is dead. I don't know how we evolved to the point where it was just NFL quarterbacks, but that idea is dead now.
Because I mean, it's our pastime now. It's where the stars play sports. But here's what I said. I said I will not watch the entire thing because I'm not a huge golf guy. I will scroll through Twitter, and whatever hits me,
catch the clips,
hits me. The only thing I saw from last night,
yeah, I saw a couple,
was Charles Barkley being very excited that Shaq was not a part of this broadcast so that he could get away from it.
Yeah, you want to talk about how saying stuff can do good for your career. Look at Chuck.
Look at Draymond.
Yeah. I saw Patrick Mahomes drinking a Coors Light.
I didn't see that. I read on Twitter as I'm scrolling that Patrick Mahomes was essentially sponsored by Coors Light here.
I think there was an F-bomb from Tom Brady early. Not totally surprising.
No.
I think it's great that Tom Brady at least has some personality now. It's sort of nice.
Yeah, very, very nice. Very welcome.
I just think, like I said before, doing that or reprising that during the pandemic with Peyton Manning and Phil, like, I think the Phil part of it was really important. I think you need the really, really good golfer to compare. Otherwise, it's just a bunch of dudes out there, and they're pretty good at golf, but they can't do some of the things that Phil Mickelson can do, you know? So it has to be that line there where it's a really, really good golfer who also is a really good personality. And Phil is one of the only guys that could bring that to the table. I don't know if Phil's going to be doing any TV things soon. We'll see on that.
Speaking of TV, and to kind of bounce back to Ryan Fitzpatrick, sources indicate he is in talks with Amazon for a quote unquote key role this season. So
nice.
That'd be kind of interesting. It'd actually
be the Charles Barkley of the NFL.
Yeah.
Is Amazon going to put together like a studio show or something like that?
I don't know what the need for a studio show for Amazon would be, because you're just going to go
live TV.
Oh, it's 7:30.
Time to turn on the app.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wonder what they'll do.
Halftime. I guess you might need a studio show during a halftime. Yeah.
Other content.
Mm-hmm.
That's what this is. All these TV things are sort of about, like, yes, you have the games, those bring the viewers to the table, but how do you present it and how do you promote it is a really big deal.
And if I, as a player, can make just as much in a booth as I can instead of doing the grueling body work of a football season, yeah, I might walk away two or three years early and collect a paycheck. Yeah,
what if you're a backup quarterback, though?
If I'm Ryan Fitzpatrick, yeah. Well, backup quarterback's easy, allegedly. Yeah,
exactly. That's a pretty good job if you could do it for a mm-hmm. while. Look at, we've talked about our man Chase Daniel before.
Yeah. Legend at the bank.
Hasn't done a damn thing in his entire career.
Not a thing.
Not one single thing. But shout out to Chase Daniel. Josh's top five is up next. What is Josh's top five today?
Well, you know, it sort of rolls into one here with Drew Timmy coming back.
Best mustaches?
Yes, actually. Top five all-time sports mustaches.
Sports mustaches.
Fitzpatrick had a great beard for mm-hmm. a long time. You know, we've talked about it off and on the last week or so with Miles Teller. Matt Carpenter is with the Yankees. He's mashing.
Well, Timmy had the Fu Manchu mm-hmm. as well for a while. I wonder what he'll go with next year in his final year in college.
So we're going to do Top five all time sports mustaches.
All right, we have that. And Martie Cordaro will join us at 1:15. All still to come on the Connor Happer Show on 1620 The Zone.
Zone, taste of our takes. Sharp and betting in the morning.
So the rhythm of the game was not very good.
What are you, Janet Jackson or somebody?
It's the rhythm of the night.
Oh my gosh.
I'm going to go into
full. No. You should have just stayed with Janet.
I asked before I said.
We'll just be a part of the Rhythm Nation.
I thought Rhythm was a dancer.
Oh my gosh.
Now, see ya.
For more, tune in every day to 1620 AM or go to 1620thezone.com. Your Omaha area forecast presented by Funplex Water Park and Rides from the KETV NewsWatch 7 Weather Center on 1620 The Zone.
Mostly sunny and warm for your Thursday with a high today in Omaha near 80 degrees with low humidity. Expect an afternoon breeze with westerly winds up to 20 miles an hour. Tonight, becoming partly cloudy, a tad cool with a low near 53 and light winds. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KETV NewsWatch 7.
More with Connor and Josh after this.
We're going to have an extensive professional relationship, my man.
On 1620, The Zone.
Here are your three Sour Patch Kids slush floats. Enjoy your Sonic.
Ice cream.
Boom.
Sour Patch Kids bits.
Boom.
A slush.
Take a bite, mm-hmm. And then we'll all harmonize.
It's sour than sweet, now in a cold treat. Introducing the Sonic Sour Patch Kids slush float with 100% real ice cream, Sour Patch Kids watermelon flavor slush, and even more Sour Patch Kids on top, all for only $2.99 for a limited time at Sonic. Sour Patch Kids is a trademark of Mondelez International Group used under license. Mobile ordering available at select locations. Hours may vary. Limited time only at participating Sonic drive-ins.
At Dingman's, our first priority is protecting your safety. We are here to be your personal advocate to ensure you receive safe, proper repairs by the highest skilled technicians in the industry. Stop in to experience the Dingman difference today. At Dingman's, we would rather be the best than apologize for anything less.
Hi guys, it's Andrew with Brookside Medical Clinic. Is erectile dysfunction damaging your relationship? Are you sick of the pill and all the side effects? Well, welcome to the future. We have a major medical breakthrough. Brookside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of wave therapy. Backed by 60 clinical studies, our technology uses pressure waves to repair and open up blood vessels. We've helped countless men get rid of their ED. But what is the true end result? Their relationship, even their lives, improve drastically. If you're ready to regain your love life, call us right now, and not only will the assessment and ultrasound be free, we'll also give you a gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. It almost never fails. This is worth $550, and it's free to callers right now. 402-671-7777. That's 402-671-7777. Put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and experience what I call the happiness ripple effect. Call Brookside Medical Clinic now. 402-671-7777.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language. Like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
3 weeks. It's incredible. After 3 weeks, I'm on vacation in Paris, having a conversation in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
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 Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's B-A-B-B-E-L.com. Babbel.com.
For thousands across the heartland, summer means one thing: hunger. Having extra mouths to feed, paired with the rising cost of food, puts an additional strain on already tight budgets. Families need your support now more than ever. Stop by the Food Bank for the Heartland's Stuff the Truck event on Saturday, June 11th, at the Baker's Lakeside location off 173rd and Center from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Your donations of non-perishable items will fill tables with food and hearts with hope. Help the Food Bank strike out hunger this summer.
Venture X from Capital One is the travel card for people always asking,
where next?
You earn 10x miles on hotels and rental cars, and 5x miles on flights booked through Capital One Travel, and 2x miles on everything else you buy with Venture X. Plus, receive premium travel benefits like access to over 1,300 airport lounges. The Venture X card from Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com for details.
My friend and I are taking a trip to Mexico this year, but neither of us speak Spanish. So we downloaded Babbel and started learning Spanish fast.
Want to get conversational in another language in as little as 3 weeks? Babbel's quick 10-minute lessons were designed by language experts to be the most efficient and effective way to learn a new language.
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
Babbel, language for life, celebrating 10 million subscriptions sold. Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's BABBEL.com.
All right, back here on the Connor Happer Show, 1620 The Zone, 1620TheZone.com. You can also find us there streaming, where Josh has really cool graphics. Because graphic design is his passion.
My passion, Connor.
People forget that sometimes.
Eat, sleep, and breathe graphics.
You're very good at it. You always were, but it looks good. It's a sharp look. I'm a little biased. I think we have the sharpest look of all the shows.
I think our presentation is the best. I agree.
We'll take that. Other shows.
You disagree? Come at me.
Speak to Josh. Josh's top five is coming up here. We'll have Martie Cordaro in the 1 o'clock hour on ALS Day in Major League Baseball and his two teams in our city here, which are pretty fun watches right now.
He's got quite the portfolio.
Yeah, not bad. Not bad. And he's everywhere, too. I don't know if you've ever seen him out there at Werner Park. He's doing a little bit of everything on a game night.
I don't know when this guy watches all the Star Wars.
It's a great question. Maybe we'll ask that.
Does he not sleep? It's possible.
All right, Josh, top five mustaches.
Top five all-time sports mustaches in honor of Drew Timmy returning to Gonzaga.
Got
to
be some Yankees on here.
There's only one baseball player.
And it's not a Yankee?
I don't think so. It's not how I remember this person. Might have done a stint there.
Gosh, come on. Take forever.
Number five.
Number five came down to Dale Earnhardt versus Mike Ditka.
Whoa. Okay. That's,
yeah.
If we're talking about those two to even crack the list,
yeah,
this is a good start.
Exactly.
Give me Dale.
Dale Earnhardt is number five.
Yes.
Ditka's has not aged well. It's turned blonde almost. Like it has not aged well.
He's getting way up there.
Prime Ditka mustache, maybe he's better. But yeah. Dale seems fuller. It's that flat push broom style. Both iconic stashers. Dale's just looks better.
Praise Dale, praise Dale.
Dale actually shaved it one weekend in the mid-90s to improve snorkeling. He couldn't get the intimidator snorkeled. He couldn't get the mask to seal right. And they're like, you know, you'd be a lot better at this if you shaved your mustache. And he went, okay, I will.
Well, he was that committed to snorkeling?
Apparently, for one weekend. We all pick up hobbies for a week. And then we're like, you know what? I'm going to put that down. That's not for me. I thought I was going to be a snorkel guy.
I had that good of a mustache, I don't think that I would shave it just to snorkel for one day.
Yeah. No, I've shaved the brand. I need to commit to this.
On the other hand, I have shaved off my beard just to have a mustache for a bit for a weekend. And it caused me great pain afterwards.
You tweeted that picture.
Yeah.
Yesterday?
Yes.
I don't know. Time is a flat circle.
It was yesterday.
But yeah, pretty impressive.
It caused me great pain afterwards because you have a mustache. Then you have to make the decision of, all right, am I just going to live life with a mustache now and wait for the rest of the beard to come back?
Mm-hmm.
Or am I going to start anew? And I started anew.
Yeah.
And as we know, I have a baby face. Some people have called me adult Bobby Hill.
You know, hadn't thought of that.
Yeah.
Feels accurate.
You'd thank Schaefer for that one.
Did you feel when you had a mustache that
I could be a co-op? Yes.
That people,
you a co-op? Are you a co-op? Maybe, you a knock?
Maybe go bleep yourself. You a Southie?
Number four.
my question was not going to top that, so I just pressed forward.
Yeah.
Number four is Andy Reid.
Yeah.
The walrus style is a...
Do we have an image of Andy without a mustache?
Ooh, good question. It's a bold look. It's a bit messy, the walrus style mustache. You need a body type that matches it, and Andy has that. You need almost a scowl.
Yeah, it looks
scowl.
Like he can kind of like shake it around a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
One
yep.
of those.
Get
yeah.
it to wiggle. Like, I'll bet that's his mating ritual with his wife. Like, oh no, he's wiggling the mustache. That means he wants it.
I cannot find an image of Andy Reid without a mustache.
Really?
Even when he was the coach of the Eagles.
Okay.
It appears as if this has just been his thing.
Well, it is a powerful mustache. It has its own Twitter account.
Absolutely. It deserves its own Twitter
mm-hmm.
account.
And
there have been I'm seeing one where he has a full beard.
Okay, how's that look?
It detracts from the mustache, obviously.
Mm-hmm. I assume this has all got to be when he was younger.
Yeah, this is a while ago. But yeah, full bushy mustache now, and he's made it a part of his identity. Nice job.
Absolutely.
Combination of 3 and 5.
Number 3.
A controversial selection because I'm pretty sure it's a bit, but he's owned it. It's Gardner Minshew.
Mm. Sort of controversial, yeah. It's definitely not because he's one of those guys who could look, he could pull off any hairstyle and any facial hairstyle.
Yeah. It's majestic. It evolves. It's gone through several different looks. The Eagles quarterback. People forget that.
I'm always so jealous of the guy who could do so many different hairstyles and facial hairstyles.
Yeah, and have them all work
yeah.
for whatever reason.
He really does own it.
The Eagles quarterback takes more daring risks with his facial hair than he does with his on-the-field play. And his...
All right, yeah, I go. Okay, I got you. All right, I think you were waiting. I thought you were waiting for me to respond there. That's funny. That's funny.
Okay. Happer's meme guy texts the show because you can do that now.
Yes, you can.
Raise hell, praise Dale.
People forget to do that sometimes.
Baker
Mayfield's another one who can do the multiple hairstyles and beard styles.
Yeah, he's gone through several looks.
Yep.
Maybe he'll go through the I've gotten myself out of Cleveland look soon, but... Seems like that hasn't happened yet.
We still have the picture of Gardner Minshew at after the Washington State game where everybody kind of rushed the field and Minshew slapped a fake mustache on Leach.
Yes.
And Leach looks ridiculous.
What a pairing that was.
Yeah. Controversial, but okay. You made a good case for it.
Thank you.
Here comes two.
Number two.
Number two is Hulk Hogan.
A look
for the ages, whether it be clean shaven or painted on stubble. The blonde handlebars stayed put and have for the last 4 decades plus.
I'm currently looking at a picture of Hulk Hogan without a mustache, and it is alarming.
Now, in doing my top 5 research here, I learned that Hulk Hogan's mustache, because I would have called it a handlebar, and I did. It's a horseshoe mustache.
He's had different iterations of it as well. Horseshoe.
It's called the horseshoe mustache.
He's had the Fu Manchu at times, right?
Yeah.
Did they do a bit on WWE once where they shaved his mustache? I'm looking at a...
That wouldn't shock me.
A YouTube clip uploaded by Old School Wrestling Clips.
Okay.
Hulk Hogan gets jumped by the Dungeon of Doom and has his mustache shaved off.
Oh, wow.
WCW.
Wow. Yeah, look at this. I'll dip in. Not ashamed. Skip this ad.
Probably not a great idea to play it over the air.
No, I'm not going to play it over
okay,
the air.
Okay, just say, yeah.
Oh, wow. Why is it 6.5 minutes? Oh, he's in a neck brace. Hulkster.
Yeah, what's can't wrong? Get out.
Oh, there's the giant Paul White from The Waterboy, Captain Insano. He shows no mercy. People forget that. Oh, gosh, he broke his neck. Look at that. Just snapped it in two like a 90s
no.
action movie. And here they ooh.
Yeah, pretty iconic.
Oh, this is, I don't know who he's at, but this is Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Of course.
Former running mate of Hulk Hogan. Now playing the bad side and barbering that mustache.
Pretty iconic stuff from the Hulkster, for sure.
Yeah. Should we do number one?
We should. This is our baseball player.
This is, yes. This is our baseball player.
There's two really good options here.
Okay.
Make it so, number one.
Number one.
The greatest sports mustache of all time is Raleigh Fingers.
Yeah.
Yeah. The most iconic facial hair in sports history. Often imitated, never duplicated.
And the fact that his name was Raleigh Fingers.
It helps. It helps with the aesthetic, the whole thing.
I mean, he was around baseball after his playing career, coaching for, I think, a couple different franchises. And his hair had turned white, gray, and then white. But his mustache remained black.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Waxed, I assume.
I don't know what the method was.
Okay.
But his mustache really has not wavered.
No.
Over all of these years.
It started as a joke with his Oakland teammate, Reggie Jackson. And then a bunch of guys in the clubhouse grew mustaches. And the Oakland A's owners said, okay, anyone who has a mustache on opening day gets an extra $300 because he saw a marketing opportunity there or something. I don't know all the details of that story. But then at the end of his career, he's wanting to get into managing. He's thinking about maybe I'll play one more place and then I'll retire. He got some interest from the Reds to join their pitching staff. And then Nazi Marge Schott instituted a no facial hair rule, and he said, well, I'm Raleigh Fingers, certainly you'll let me keep my mustache.
Being grandfathered in here.
And Marge Schott, known for being just an all-around pleasant person to deal with, not at all, said, no, you will not be included in this. So if you come to Cincinnati, you will shave that thing off of your face. He said, thank you, ma'am, but I must decline your offer.
Awesome.
The mustache stays.
Yep. If it's a part of you, it's a part of you.
Yeah.
He's committed to the bit.
I mean, he bought crates of that mustache wax. He's not just going to throw it out.
He is committed to the bit. Mm-hmm. And that, once again, we appreciate. Surprised to not see any Yankees on here ever. There's been some really good and bad ones over the years.
Who would be your Yankee that you put on here? Would it be Giambi?
That would go more in like the bad category.
Yeah,
it was shocking. It was shocking when they made Damon, when Damon went over and he didn't have a mustache. He went bald facial hair.
That was jarring every time.
Very, very shocking. Goose Gossage, I think, would be near the top of the list.
Goose would have been in seventh or eighth.
Yeah.
Yeah. But then I thought, you know what? This is pretty much Hulk Hogan's.
Mattingly had a pretty killer one. And in the '90s, I don't know that it was ever better than in the '90s.
Yeah.
People were rocking the mustaches in the '90s.
Mattingly had a good one for sure.
There's Josh's top five mustaches in sports. You can feel free to comment at Happer Show or text us 402-951-1620. Marty Cordaro coming up here in just a little bit. We'll come back with more up next, but first, FanDuel Sportsbook, official betting partner of the 75th NBA Finals, which begin tonight. And to celebrate 75 years of the NBA, have you heard it's the 75th year of the NBA? We're giving all customers a $75 referral bonus. That's right. You'll get $75 in site credit when you invite your friends to join America's number one sportsbook. That is FanDuel Sportsbook. You invite your friends from the app. You make sure they sign up with your referral link. And then as soon as your friend makes any bet of at least $10, why not start tonight on game one of the NBA Finals, you both get the $75 bonus, and the offer ends when the game tips off tonight. So get your bets in. This offer is going away when game one tips off tonight. Don't miss your chance to bet the finals with a bonus. And if you're new to FanDuel, you can sign up with promo code Happer to get your free bets after your first bet. Promo code Happer, H-A-P-P-E-R. Head over to the FanDuel Sportsbook. Invite your friends today to get $75 in sportsbook credit. 21 plus, present in Iowa. Referred players must wager $10 or more within 28 days after signing up. Limit 10 referrals. Site credit is non-withdrawable and expires after 7 days. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
Remember, no matter how you listen, it's still AM radio. 1620, The Zone.
There are actually two kinds of cigars. The first is the one you smoke with beloved family and friends. The second, the one you enjoy with friends you've just met. And you'll find both at Hearth Cigars and Pipes Lounge. At Hearth Cigars and Pipes Lounge, there's a well-stocked humidor with some of the best bands from around the world and a bar with your favorite cocktails and other drinkables. So what do you say? Which cigar will you be enjoying tonight? Hearth Cigars and Pipes Lounge, just off I-680 and 48th Street next to Cubby's.
Living is all about great experiences. We invite you to experience everything that Sarpy County has to offer. The great outdoors awaits you at Fontenelle Forest or Schramm State Park. As the pro sports capital of Nebraska, grab your family and enjoy an Omaha Storm Chasers or Union Omaha game at Werner Park. Nothing beats watching your child catch their first foul ball or perhaps a fish at one of Sarpy's many reservoirs. Visit GoSarpy.com to plan your next experience this spring.
Did you know that Kentucky bluegrass isn't from Kentucky? It came from Europe. And what we call Dutch elm disease actually originated in Asia. This is Chuck Monaco with CM's Outdoor, now part of the Ryan Lawn and Tree family. And while you may know us as experts in everything lawn, trees, and landscape, you may not know that we're also experts in pest control. After all, you want to do more than just look at your beautiful lawn. You want to fully enjoy it. A certified CM's and Ryan Pest Control Pro can free your outdoor oasis from ants and spiders, fleas and ticks, rodents, mosquitoes, and more. Our home insect barrier won't let them escape inside either. And unlike other companies, our employee owner Pest Control Pros are cross-trained in plant science to help make sure that your beautiful and livable landscape stays that way. Visit bestomahalawn.com for a free estimate. Sign up for our complete Pest Guard Plus annual program, and your first application is free. Enjoy a pest-free summer at bestomahalawn.com.
Join Blur Parties at Hilton Omaha this June as we host a premier college baseball championship tailgate. Experience an all-inclusive full bar and buffet, TV, music, and a variety of tailgate games. Book a corporate tailgate event or just hang out with friends. The best part is we're located on the south side of Charles Schwab Field at the Hilton Omaha. Visit blurparties.com to buy tickets or to find out about sponsorship opportunities. That's blurparties.com, your college baseball and football tailgate destination.
Prescription products require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if a prescription is appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information. Subscription required. Refund available for 60 days after purchase.
Having an issue with ED might begin in the bedroom, but it doesn't end there. It can also do a number on your confidence. But know this, you're not alone. 30 million guys deal with ED in the U.S. Fortunately, treating ED is now more straightforward and less awkward than ever, thanks to Hims. Through Hims, you can get the generic form of Viagra, which uses the same active ingredient, for just $3 per use. Just go to 4hims.com and chat with a medical provider online, and if appropriate, you'll be prescribed the ED medication that's best for you. And it'll be shipped free to your door in discreet packaging. Simple. Plus, Hims gives you unlimited follow-up visits with medical providers. Get your confidence back at 4hims.com. Love your results or your money back. To get started today, go to 4hims.com/radio. That's 4hims.com/radio for your free visit. forhims.com/radio.
All right, welcome back. More of the Connor Happer Show, 1620 The Zone, 1620thezone.com. Interesting news out of college baseball this morning as the regionals kick off tomorrow. They notoriously do not include North Carolina State, left on the bubble on selection Monday, Sunday, Monday. Like I said, the days all combined together. But with NC State, they had a guy this year by the name of Tommy White, a.k.a. Tommy Tanks. We talked about him quite a while ago. He started off the season on unprecedented tear. He set the NCAA freshman record for home runs this year. And Tommy Tanks, as they're calling him, is in the portal. So are we about to find, and this is always the speculation when this stuff comes around. What is this about? What does he want? Right? But we may be about to find out if there's any NIL money for college baseball. Because if there was ever a guy, it would be him. Now he could go to junior college for a couple of years. He could go to another school for a couple of years and make himself a sort of draftable pro. I don't know if it's about pro aspirations. I don't know if it's about getting closer to home. I think he's from Florida. I don't know. We don't know exactly what it's about, but you can bet that there will be some sort of bidding war. At least somebody's going to be getting involved here. Or knocking on the door, grabbing Tommy Tank's number and saying, "Hey, I know, you know, your plan's probably to go home or whatever it might be. I'm not sure what you're looking into, but here at LSU, we have a little fund going, and you can make some money off this. You're already very profitable. You come with a nickname, Tommy Tanks. Boom, marketability right there.
We can sell that.
Yeah, that's doable." Which I feel like, by the way, in the whole talk over the summer of like acquiring football players basically for money, we sort of got away from like the marketability of student athletes, and we more just went to like, yeah, this guy is good.
I'll buy that player because he's good.
He is good at football, which, you know, once again, not the original intent of the old NIL. I was reading this story, and shout out to Ross, who sent this to me earlier on the Equitable Bank inbox over email at Connor@1620thezone.com. And he sent me an article from Cleveland.com. Doug LaMaurice wrote, Ohio State believes it needs $13 million in NIL money to keep its football roster together. So Ryan Day and company are now in the business of telling the boosters and the donors exactly what they, you know, what they need, and broken down to specific positions. Basically, we're talking about a sort of self-imposed salary cap and a budget for like each position, which is just, I mean, insane from where we're at like a year ago in the sport. Doug writes, speaking to about 100 members of the Columbus business community on Thursday morning, Ohio State football coach Ryan Day put a name, image, likeness price tag on what he believes it'll take to keep the Ohio State football roster together. Once again, speaking to a business community.
He published his grocery list.
Yeah, wonder who was in there.
Yeah.
$13 million. To some schools engaged in NIL payments at the highest level right now, that number might sound small and quaint. To many other schools in the Big Ten, it may sound gigantic and impossible. As usual, it's a number that Ohio State puts in the thick of the latest changes to college sports, as the Buckeyes always say they seek to straddle a line of keeping up without going too far. We haven't seen it spelled out and written out that way either. They set the bar at $13 million. That would include money offered to players by outside collectives that have already formed to pay Ohio State players. And it would include this new brand ambassador program. No NIL deal can demand that the player stay at Ohio State in order to be paid, as the NIL deals can't be directly tied to performance. There's no touchdown bonuses or anything like that. But Ohio State feels it has to do something more. Thursday morning, they made their case to people who can give them money, a $13 million case. So you just wonder if there's any money in there for baseball. Makes sense to ask, though. And that's basically what Ryan Day did yesterday. NBA Finals tonight on the call, Mark Jones and Mark Jackson, who are not Jeff Van Gundy and Mike Breen.
Couple of marks on the call. Breen ends a streak of 91 straight NBA Finals games dating back to 06. Van Gundy is called 85 straight.
Jeez.
Going back to 2007. So it'll sound and look a little different on ABC tonight. Kind of wish they would have got Doris Burke involved.
Doesn't that tell you, though, like I mentioned this with Joe Buck in the World Series, and people might not. Now, I think everybody universally sort of likes Mike Breen. He's really good at what he does. I like Joe Buck, but there's something to just being there, being the voice of a thing.
Just always being there.
For 20 years. Mm-hmm. That is, that's pretty cool. So when you think NBA Finals, you think, I don't know, rebound kicked out to Ray Allen, bang. That's what I think of anyway.
Oh, yeah.
We're not going to get that tonight, sadly.
Not tonight. Got a little COVID running through the ABC broadcast
game
team.
Game 2 is Monday?
Sunday. Woj won't be there tonight as well for whatever he was doing.
All right, so we may get it on, may get it Sunday, but not tonight.
Hey, Aaron Judge had a home run.
Shocker. Martie Cordaro is coming up next. It is ALS Day across baseball, and Marty's done some great work in that field. Also, he's got two pretty good teams right now here in our city. We'll chat with the Prez next here on 1620 The Zone.
The Connor Happer Show.
Who's pitching tonight?
You Darvish, having a great year.
The Connor Happer Show.
I know about that guy.
On 1620, The Zone.
What a mess.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone.
The Zone Inbox is brought to you by Equitable Bank. We take banking personally. Email me, Connor Happer, with The Connor Happer Show at Connor, C-O-N-N-O-R, at 1620thezone.com. Send me your love, your hate, and maybe a few hot takes. The Zone Inbox, presented by Equitable Bank.
Why are we experts in total pest control? Because what good is a beautiful lawn if bugs and pests keep you from going out and enjoying it? This is Chuck Monaco of CM's Outdoor, now part of the Ryan Lawn and Tree family. Our CM's and Ryan pros are known as the very best at getting rid of the nasty critters that enjoy chewing on your lawn, shrubs, and trees. So it only makes sense that we would also eliminate those annoying pests that see you as a tasty snack. Introducing Pest Guard Plus. We've combined our four most popular home pest control services into one year-round program. It includes keeping bugs out of your home, flea and tick control, mosquito, and rodent control. Pest Guard Plus keeps pests out of your home and out of your yard, so you can enjoy summer indoors and out. Visit bestomahalawn.com to learn more and receive a free estimate. Sign up now for Pest Guard Plus, and your first application is free. Enjoy a pest-free summer with Pest Guard Plus at bestomahalawn.com. That's bestomahalawn.com.
1620 The Zone, live and local, broadcasting 6A to 6P in the Host Coffee Zone studio. Host Coffee, offering office break room refreshment services to Omaha and Lincoln metro area businesses. Discover a better break room solution for your office at sales@hostcoffee.net.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language, like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
3 weeks. It's incredible. After 3 weeks, I'm on vacation in Paris, having a conversation in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
Babbel.
Babbel. Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's B-A-B-B-E-L.com. Babbel.com.
Smart homeowners know that proper maintenance of their home's AC can save a bundle in the long run. Trust our comfort specialists at 1 Hour Heating and Air Conditioning to keep your AC running strong. A proactive tune-up can actually help your AC run more efficiently and save you money on your electric bill. Just call 402-788-1234 to schedule your preseason tune-up for just $79.
Always on time, or you don't pay a dime.
Call 402-788-1234.
Whoa, Greg's up.
He's never up this early.
Hey, guys.
Okay, so this is called the Bell Breakfast Box from Taco Bell.
Oh, thanks. I can read.
And that's a coffee. Helps you open your eyes.
And that's a breakfast burrito. You can start from either end.
You guys always this condescending in the morning?
Pretty much.
Wake up with the new $5 Bell Breakfast Box, filled with a grande toasted breakfast burrito, hash brown, two Cinnabon Delights, and a coffee. At limited participating Taco Bell locations near you during breakfast hours only. Contact local store for prices, hours, and participation, which vary. Tax extra. Drinks excludes freezes.
Listen for the screwball of the day this week on Unsportsmanlike Conduct. Could be someone screwy or nutty, but worthy of the screwball of the day title. Brought to you by Screwball Peanut Butter Whiskey, the original peanut butter whiskey, now available near you.
Shop Woodhouse Place Hyundai and Nissan, 144th and Giles, KOZN Bellevue, Omaha, Council Bluffs.
All right, welcome back in. Happy Thursday. More of the Connor Happer Show here on 1620 The Zone, 1620thezone.com. We are happy to be joined by Omaha Prez, Union Omaha Prez, and Omaha Storm Chasers President Martie Cordaro on the phone now. Martie, hello. How are you?
Connor, how are you?
I am good. You're running around like crazy nowadays, even more so with Union Omaha going on. I wanted to ask about Union Omaha first. How have you seen, I mean, what is this U.S. Open Cup run sort of done for Union Omaha and its community?
Well, you know, from a soccer perspective, you know, we're being talked about nationally, obviously, and even internationally to some degree. And, you know, our crest has gotten noticed and has been called the best crest in North American professional soccer. Again, I don't know who gives out awards for that, but it is cool to hear. It's cool to hear that, you know, a commentator, you know, on online and on television saying that. And our merchandise sales have reflected that. You know, we've had hundreds of online orders over the last week since we beat Minnesota United. And, you know, this team just continues to win games that maybe it shouldn't win. I stutter and I don't say that with confidence, because maybe they should be winning. You know, maybe Coach Mims has put together a squad that is talented enough to continue this run, and we'll find that out on June 22nd. But you know, it's been a great run. The USL League One season is very young. We've played half as many games as a handful of squads, and you know, with our home season schedule being very backloaded, you know, we're very bullish on the rest of the regular season as well.
Yeah, getting some national attention, like you said, but you know, your audience is always going to be local. This is sort of what it takes, though. A run like this and a string of wins, and then you know, it really catches on locally, and that could last. I mean, you've seen this before. That could last for a long time. What they're doing right now could have a big impact on its fan base for a while.
Well, I think it does legitimize what, you know, we've done on the field itself from a soccer technical perspective. You know, Coach Mims has put together a great squad. You know, arguably Rashid Nuhu is one of the top goalkeepers in America, not just at League One. Connor Doyle, an unbelievable captain for us, obviously played in Creighton. He's played in the MLS, and he's leading virtually an all-new squad. And, yes, there are some other returning names and faces. I don't want to mention any others that, you know, at the risk of leaving some out, but you know, it's an early season, and this run with the Open Cup is going to be interesting to see if it can continue past 40. That would be an unbelievable accomplishment for us, considering, you know, they are, you know, our metro areas, and I'm using air quotes right now, MLS club. So it would be quite the victory if we can continue the run on June 22nd down in Kansas City.
Hey, how does it actually work? Do you know? Well, I'm sure you know, but can you get, if you were to win that match, can you get a home match at Warner Park in the next round?
From what I'm told, that there will be a draw for the semifinal and the final games, much like there was for the round of 16 and 8. I assume it's a ping pong ball system like all the others have been. But yes, you know, my understanding is we could host, and whether Warner Park is available or not, or UNO or Creighton, and you know, it's premature to talk about that. But how cool would that to be able to host in the Omaha Metro a semi or a final?
Yeah, it'd be awesome. And this is another thing I've been talking around with people at Warner Park who have done it and seen it. The changeover from baseball, and you could barely notice when you go out there for a baseball game. Just the little lines on the field, and those go away after a period of time. But one night it's a soccer field, the next night it's a baseball field, and it's seamless. You find a way to make it work. What's that sort of changeover like? I'm sure it's an all hands on deck thing.
Well, it's easy for me to say what it's like, but our groundskeeper Zach Ricketts, his assistant Tom Walter, and then our ops crew, you know, led by Steve Farns, they do an amazing job. They really do. And you're right; you can see the lines because they're a different shade of green, you know, when we paint over the white soccer lines. But beyond that, the diamond, the infield skin, the mound, everything looks fantastic. And the field has played, you know, quite well after the changeovers. And that's a testament to the, you know, the dedication, the effort, because, you know, we played soccer Saturday night. Sunday, Monday was holiday weekend, and our grounds and ops crew were at the ballpark changing that turf over. And it's about a 48 to 56 hour process, and our guys are really doing a great job of that.
Yeah. Marty Cordaro is with us. He's the president of Union Omaha and the Omaha Storm Chasers. All right. So we had you on today because you're involved very closely with ALS and it's Lou Gehrig Day across Major League Baseball today. So where does this connection go back to for you, and why are you so involved with this?
You know, I was first introduced to what amyotrophic lateral sclerosis is, or ALS, or Lou Gehrig's disease. Back in 2003, 2004, I was in Birmingham. It was my second minor league baseball stop, and we had a massive Lou Gehrig jersey, and it was one of those inflatable jerseys, and fans could make a donation, and they signed their name to it, and it was a fundraiser for the local chapter there in Birmingham area. That's really when I became educated on the surface. Then I went to Battle Creek, Michigan, and that was my first GM job. And as I became more engaged in the community, we started working with the Southwest Michigan chapter for the ALS Association. And that was the first time we started hosting events or doing things at our ballpark. And then when I moved to Omaha, I literally looked in the Yellow Pages, and there were a couple of ALS groups that are in the metro here. And I called the ALS Association. That's the one that is nationally tied to fundraising and doing research and trying to make progress, you know, at a national level, international level. And I called and said, hey, I'm here. I'm ready to be a volunteer. That was fall of 06, winter of 06, 07. And I've been engaged ever since with the ALS group here. And it's become a passion. You know, my former administrative assistant in my office, Dana, she lost her husband, David, years ago. And then there are so many families and so many other stories that I could tell you. But one, I'll say Kurt and Mary Mance are very close to me. Kurt lost his battle 3 years ago with ALS, but I did travel in 2014 to March in D.C. and to visit with, you know, our congressional members on some bills that we were focused on getting pushed through. And that really changed my perspective, you know, spending 3 days with them and being a part of seeing someone wheelchair bound that really wasn't speaking and was spelling things out with his feet. Kurt was an amazing man. He used to do yard work with his feet when that was the last two remaining limbs that he had use of. And 2014 really cemented, you know, my long-term commitment to finding a cure one day and hoping to find some treatment that can help people is there in their last few years, and then hopefully one day a cure.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you guys do so many great things out at the ballpark to raise awareness and in some cases raise funds for stuff like this. I mean, what in baseball has really wrapped its arms around it, obviously with the obvious connection to Lou Gehrig. I guess what can people sort of do, or what would you suggest that they should do to, if they want to be more involved?
Well, the walk is going to be, the Omaha Walk is at Warner Park every August. This year is no different. We would love for family members, we would love for community members to come learn a little bit more about ALS. And if you go to ALS Association MidAmerica chapter, that is the best place to get information, whether that's the website or the Facebook page, but that will give you information. You know, about the walk that will happen August 20th out at Warner Park. So that's a way to get introduced. Beyond that, you know, there's always opportunities for volunteers. There's always opportunities to donate money. If you're on Twitter, I suggest following Brian Wallach. You can learn a lot. Brian was someone who worked in D.C. in politics, and he has become quite the champion for ALS and really shares his life day by day, sometimes hour by hour, on what his family is going through. So you can really understand what someone with this terminal disease is going through and ultimately will die from.
Yeah. Marty, well, we appreciate that. And we appreciate your time as always. Great stuff. And we'll see you out at the ballpark soon.
Connor, thank you so much, and we really appreciate the support that you give to be able to talk about Lou Gehrig Day. And, you know, we'll be doing a few things out at the ballpark tonight. I can't wait to see my friend Don Novak, who's been battling ALS for several years, out at the park, and someone will be throwing out a first pitch in his honor tonight at the park. But 7:05 first pitch for the Chasers tonight if fans want to come out on Lou Gehrig Day.
Excellent. Should be a beautiful night. Talk to you later, Marty.
Thank you, Connor.
That is Marty Cordaro, the president. The Omaha Storm Chasers. Yeah, they'll do some stuff at the ballpark tonight. So 81 years ago today, Lou Gehrig passed away. So this is MLB sort of wrapping their arms around it. And Marty's been on the forefront of this for a few years now. And baseball's sort of catching up. Like I said, obvious connection there with Lou Gehrig. And, you know, it is a tough thing to sort of watch. You know, when people have this disease, and so it makes it sort of, I don't know, easier to want to wrap your arms around it when you sort of see what can happen. And baseball's sort of catching up now.
Yeah, when you sort of learn about what the disease does, I think a lot of us were victim to this when we were all doing the ice bucket challenge.
Sure.
We didn't really know why we were doing it. It was just something fun and trendy to do. Yeah. But when you learn just how it imprisons the patient within their own body, you really want to help when you learn kind of the details and the suffering that the disease causes.
Yeah, that's not the end of the good things that Marty and the crew are doing over there, but it's certainly a banner thing that they, like I said, sort of wrap their arms around. So thanks to him for joining, and he'll always be running around. He's always run around out there doing something or talking to someone. If you get a chance, just pull him to the side and he'll have a conversation with you about whatever. He enjoys talking to people. We will come back more up next on the Connor Happer Show on 1620 The Zone.
Previously on Unsportsmanlike Conduct.
What's more likely to happen? A human winning the horse racing triple crown or a horse winning the baseball triple crown?
It's the human winning the horse triple crown.
Has to be, right?
Because the horse has no opposable thumbs. How are they going to pitch? How are they going to hit?
Yeah, dumbass horses. Then they'll probably just start walking them all the time. We're walking the horse. Well, I guess that you can't win the triple crown getting walked all the time.
Unsportsmanlike Conduct with John Bishop and Josh Peterson. Weekdays 2 to 6 on 1620 The Zone. Your Omaha area forecast presented by Funplex Water Park and Rides from the KETV NewsWatch 7 Weather Center on 1620 The Zone.
Mostly sunny and warm for your Thursday with a high today in Omaha near 80 degrees with low humidity. Expect an afternoon breeze with westerly winds up to 20 miles an hour. tonight, becoming partly cloudy, a tad cool with a low near 53 and light winds. I'm meteorologist Caitlin Harvey with KETV News Watch 7.
Dads want steak. Visit omahasteaks.com, type Bishop in the search bar, and order the Dads Want Steak Pack today.
Email Sharp and Benning on Equitable Bank inbox with your love, your hate, whatever your hot takes are. We're here for you. The Zone inbox is brought to you by Equitable Bank. We take banking personally. We want to hear from you on the Equitable Bank Zone inbox. Damon Benning from Sharp and Benning in the morning. When Lee Franklin Jr. moved to Omaha, he brought his love for Louisiana cooking with him. That's when he and his partner, Montoya Johnson, opened a Taste of New Orleans Creole Cafe inside of Ted and Wally's in Benson. A Taste of New Orleans is the go-to spot in the 402 for authentic Cajun and Creole cuisine. Andouille fries and sausage, beignets, po' boys, jambalaya gumbo, and so much more. A Taste of New Orleans Creole Cafe inside of Ted and Wally's in Benson. And be on the lookout for their food truck coming to a stop near you.
Malarkey shingles are durable, high performance, impact resistant, and beautiful. Carp's Complete Home Exteriors is a certified Malarkey shingle residential contractor. For a free estimate, call Carp's Complete Exteriors or visit carpsomaha.com.
CM's Outdoor, now a proud part of Ryan Lawn and Tree. For a limited time, get your first lawn or pest application for free. Schedule a free estimate at bestomahalawn.com. That's bestomahalawn.com.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're speaking another language. Like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right. And they're designed by real language teachers, so you learn how to have real-world conversations, things you'll actually use.
3 weeks. It's incredible. After 3 weeks, I'm on vacation in Paris, having a conversation in French.
There's all kinds of ways to learn. Use Babbel's podcasts or games or videos. You can even join live classes with a language teacher.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
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 Babbel. Évidemment.
Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com. Babbel.com.
Listen to 1620 The Zone anywhere, anytime. Online at 1620thezone.com. And on the 1620 The Zone mobile app, you can hear all of your 6A to 6P favorites in the 1620 The Zone app, powered by Woodhouse Auto Family.
All right, welcome back. More of the Connor Happer Show. You're in 1620 The Zone and 1620thezone.com. Big Ten rights. We're going to find out about this stuff soon and what may happen. Little pieces of information sort of starting to come out, or at least being floated. Here is John Orrand of Sports Business Journal. He's been on this for a while. He did a podcast, and he dropped a nugget or a possibility. He says, I'm just going to float this out here. That usually means something. And here he is yesterday.
Here's something that was just floated by me just last week. Imagine this on a Saturday afternoon in the fall. You have Fox with the 1 or 2 pick in the noon window, and that leads into CBS with the 1 or 2 pick or 3 pick in the late afternoon window, which leads into NBC with the 1, 2, or 3 pick in prime time. And all of a sudden you have Big Ten games going all through the day. And that's something that's, I'm not predicting that that's going to happen, but it's something that certainly has been discussed.
I mean, that makes a lot of sense. I mean, if you wanted to own the day, you'd be on 3 of the 4 networks from one to the other to the other. The question is, are there enough good games, right? This isn't the NFL. Does the Big Ten, although it's in huge markets, does it have 3 really good games every week?
Do you want to own the day, or do you want to sort of do what you have done? This is where ESPN, notice ESPN wasn't mentioned in that set of networks. This is where they sort of come into play. I do think that it's best that the Big Ten has some sort of presence on ESPN, and they will. That'd just be my guess. I do wonder if the SEC is sort of made a mistake in going basically we're exclusive ESPN. While you want to have a presence there because they're most closely connected to the college football playoff, and like it or not, they sort of operate and drive the narratives across the sport, right? What are they talking about on ESPN? That's what gets talked about. That's a simple fact that we sort of have to accept in the sports world. Whatever they choose to cover, that's going to get talked about a little bit more.
That's why we didn't care about hockey for a decade.
And now hockey's back.
Yep, hockey's back.
Right.
It's not because the players are better.
And the product is fun to watch, but maybe the product was fun to watch that whole time.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
ESPN was talking about it. We don't know. So, you know, there's a certain, like, we have to give them that.
So what channel is Versus again?
There's obviously value to being on ESPN, and the SEC is going to get, you know, the first sort of crack there because they know that. But what is the value to being everywhere else? Having an entire day of college football where he just said it there. The Big Noon game, Fox. They get the number one pick of the Big Ten game of the week, or, you know, whatever they have the rights to. There's some Big 12 in there too. They get the number one pick. So they'll put their best game there. Whatever's left goes to, whatever's left for the week goes next to CBS. This is, of course, separate from the ESPN night game, SEC night game that they're going to do, or ESPN throughout the day. Whatever's left out of that deal, the chunk of that deal, going to CBS at 2:30 because they're obvious. They have some infrastructure. They've done it before. And they are going to have a huge hole without the SEC. Then NBC. Hey, do you want to get involved? Take a primetime game. Put it at night. Put it up against ESPN. See how it does. Or put it in a different window altogether. I don't know. But there is a scenario in which all of those are covered by the Big Ten Conference. And what the second guy mentioned there at the end was, is there enough games? That I don't know. I do wonder if, like I said, I do wonder if the SEC made a mistake by going like basically all ESPN. You gotta have some sort of ESPN involvement somehow here. But the Big Ten is in the driver's seat here. They are in prime position to sort of make this whatever they like to make it. And then there's the trickle down of what's next, and the Pac-12 comes up here, and then the Big 12 is the year after that. So they're in a position to sort of get the scraps off of this, and they're going to be pretty good scraps, by the way. The Big Ten's eating good,
yeah,
but they can't eat too good. So there'll be some left. There'll be some left for the Big 12 as well. Make no mistake about it. The Big Ten is in the driver's seat here. I'm now more curious than ever to see where this whole thing sort of ends up.
It's a good strategy. Hey, let's be on every network, every time slot, and you cannot avoid our conference versus.
It's just interesting that comes out because I had assumed throughout these negotiations that we were going to end up in a pretty similar spot to where we were. What that sounds like is that there is going to be some changes.
Big Ten, not known for radical
correct,
thinking.
Correct.
And so it would be interesting.
But
and
they are now left with the whole world in their hands.
And I don't think the deal is so close to being done and announced and rolled out that I don't think those two guys talk about it if it's not a possibility, on the table.
That's definitely a real thing.
Yeah, yeah. They're too informed. They're not just, hey, you know what would be cool if we did this?
Right. It's not just an idea.
Yeah. It is something that has clearly been talked about and strongly considered if they do end up going that way, which I thought we were going to find out.
Yeah, it's going to be close. We're getting close. They were supposed to wrap up Memorial Day weekend.
Yeah. It is famously after. Memorial Day weekend.
Dot some I's, cross some T's, and let's get this thing out there. I'm super curious now.
I am too.
How much ESPN will there be? What does CBS do? Does NBC want to get involved? Those are the main questions. Because Nebraska, the Big Ten has half their rights sort of to shell out wherever they'd like to. Maybe they could dive in. Maybe they're diving into Fox a little bit. The split will be interesting too.
Yeah.
Maybe it's instead of 51% Fox, it's 60% Fox or something like that. But the rest of it, you're splitting out elsewhere. And then where does it go? That's the question that we're dealing with right now. We have poll questions to round out, and we'll tell you what to watch tonight next here in 1620 The Zone. It's game one of the NBA Finals. It's finally here, and your chance is also here to score big on the FanDuel Sportsbook. Throughout the finals, FanDuel is giving new customers $200 in free bets guaranteed. All you have to do is place your first $5 bet. Moneyline, point spreads, player props. Like I said earlier, I like the Warriors in game one. 4-point favorites right now. You parlay that with anything else. There's a billion things to bet on during a game. I'm looking at it right now. You got first basket. You could do exact correct score. I wouldn't recommend parlaying that with anything if you want to win. But, you know, there's alternate spreads. There's players to score a certain amount of points. You could parlay these things together on a same game parlay with our friends at the FanDuel Sportsbook. I know I do all of the time. Just sign up with promo code Happer. And if you haven't tried FanDuel, it's the perfect time to give it a shot because the only thing sweeter than watching the finals is cashing in. Be a part of it with the FanDuel Sportsbook. Join today with promo code Happer. Turn $5 bet into $200 in free bets, win or lose. Make every game feel like game seven with FanDuel, the official betting partner of the NBA. 21 plus and present in Iowa. First online real money wager only. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued with non-withdrawable site credit. Non-withdrawable free bets, that expires 14 days after receipt. Restrictions apply. See full terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-BETS-OFF.
The Connor Happer Show. Follow us on Twitter at Happer Show for all the latest news and views. We may even say something interesting once in a while.
Unlikely.
Really, guys? Remember, no matter how you listen, it's still AM radio. 1620, The Zone.
Want to know the difference between 42 Degrees and our competition? Our customers. With over 1,200 five-star reviews, we are proud to say that our customer service is the best in town. Curious to know what our customers rate most every time? It's our knowledge of the products and how friendly and professional our sales staff is. Stop in, talk to our staff, and see for yourself why 42 Degrees is the source by your mom's house.
In America, the future belongs to everyone. So we designed the Ford trucks of the future for everyone. Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks for 45 years straight. Made for performance and capability on and off-road. Because the trucks of the future aren't designed for a few. They're built for America. Ford F-Series. Drive one today. Based on 1977 to 2021 calendar year total sales.
Okay, team, it's summer. Your training all comes down to this. Checklist. Emma, sunscreen? Check. Alex, shades?
Yep, set.
Baby Zoe, diaper bag? We're just gonna call that a yes.
Are you ready for Funplex?
Check. We're out to the minivan.
But we can't drive.
Let's find Mom and then go to the minivan.
Yay! It's all for fun and fun for all at Funplex. 70th and Q, dude. Get your tickets now at fun-plex.com.
At Dingman's, our first priority is protecting your safety. We are here to be your personal advocate to ensure you receive safe, proper repairs by the highest skilled technicians in the industry. Vehicle technology is changing faster than ever. Performing manufacturer repair procedures is just one way we ensure your vehicle will be returned to you as safe as it was when you bought it. Visit our website at dingmans.com or stop in to experience the Dingman difference for yourself. At Dingman's, we would rather be the best than apologize for anything less.
Prescription products require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if a prescription is appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for full details and important safety information. Subscription required. Refund available for 60 days after purchase.
Having an issue with ED might begin in the bedroom, but it doesn't end there. It can also do a number on your confidence. But know this, you're not alone. 30 million guys deal with ED in the U.S. Fortunately, treating ED is now more straightforward and less awkward than ever, thanks to Hims. Through Hims, you can get the generic form of Viagra, which uses the same active ingredient for just $3 per use. Just go to 4hims.com and chat with a medical provider online. And if appropriate, you'll be prescribed the ED medication that's best for you. And it'll be shipped free to your door in discreet packaging. Simple. Plus, Hims gives you unlimited follow-up visits with medical providers. Get your confidence back at 4hims.com. Love your results or your money back. To get started today, go to 4hims.com/radio. That's 4hims.com/radio for your revisit. forhims.com/radio.
For thousands across the heartland, summer means one thing: hunger. Having extra mouths to feed, paired with the rising cost of food, puts an additional strain on already tight budgets. Families need your support now more than ever. Stop by the Food Bank for the Heartland's Stuff the Truck event on Saturday, June 11th, at the Baker's Lakeside location off 173rd and Center from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Your donations of non-perishable items will fill tables with food and hearts with hope. Help the Food Bank strike out hunger this summer.
Let's get back to the Connor Happer Show on 1620 The Zone.
Here comes the clown.
All right. Round things out on Thursday, game one of the NBA Finals. Quick prediction? Or should we do that in
For
the
me?
What to watch?
What? No, let's do it now.
Okay.
Why not?
Give me Golden State tonight.
Golden State tonight, definitely.
Definitely.
See, I'm torn because I bet the Warriors a long time ago. I didn't
think I'd
be in this position. Yes, I win either way.
Yeah, congratulations.
But you know what? Why would I pick against my team? I'll go Boston in seven.
Yeah, for the series?
Yeah. Warriors tonight, take the points.
I also like Boston, but you're a homer and I'm not. This is from a neutral stand. Actually, I'd prefer it if Boston didn't win.
Yeah.
Just America.
You're going to get sick of that Jason Tatum narrative.
Yeah. Already am.
Another 17 days of a coronation.
I'm going to take the Celtics to win the series. I just don't like, I'm just not as high on the Warriors as everybody else is. Now at the same time, they have Steph Curry. They're still very capable of hitting you with that avalanche.
Yeah, Steph Curry very famously has never won a finals MVP though.
I just sort of like the matchup.
Here's hoping. That's all right, gang. Am I right?
No.
Oh,
did aviator sunglasses ever go away?
Big crossover debate today.
I don't know. They're definitely back more.
Oakley had a moment, but I think they've been pretty persistent.
Yeah, I'll go with no. They didn't ever go away. 82% agree. So there you go. We're on the right side of history there.
It ebbs and flows.
Have you ever fallen asleep at a concert?
Ravi with a reveal during the crossover?
My answer would be no. 75% also have not fallen asleep at a concert. Do you like a thick dressing? No, I do not like a thick dressing.
It can be too thick.
69% say yes, nice. They like a thick dressing.
What, do you guys coordinate with each other?
Okay, here's what we're going to do with this poll question, guys.
It'd be the funniest if this one was end up at 69% yes. And those were the polls today.
We stuck to business during the show.
Yes, we did.
We did.
What are we watching tonight?
Tonight we're watching the finals. Game one, 8 o'clock, ABC. Boston in the finals for the first time since 2010. Golden State in the finals for the sixth time in the last eight seasons.
Yeah.
Which makes the Celtics the scrappy underdog as they continue their revenge tour. Mark Jones and Mark Jackson on the call tonight for ABC. NHL playoffs still going on. Western Conference Finals game two tonight. Edmonton at Colorado. Your Avalanche are up 1-0, Connor.
No Darcy Kemper.
Oh.
I think they called him out tonight.
Okay. 7 o'clock on TNT. The finals of the Spelling Bee are tonight on ION. Again, not on ESPN.
Also the last guy of the last round.
Yes, he has a do or die.
Do or die word.
Final entry word, I guess.
Sudden word.
Yeah. 7 o'clock on ION. LeVar Burton of Reading Rainbow fame hosts. You can watch the Women's College World Series all day on ESPN today. It is Oklahoma versus the world. Four games kick off the 39th annual Women's College World Series from Oklahoma City. But
By the way, Texas already in the next round.
Yes, Texas won game one over UCLA 7-2. The tournament originated at Seymour Smith here in Omaha. As the Sooners look to capture a national title with some local talent on that squad and a 54-2 record.
Ah, they're fine. They're fine.
Formality? You play to win the game. 7 o'clock on Bravo tonight. Top Chef season 19 finale from Tucson? Not the most exotic locale. A good locale. Not the most exotic locale.
Nope.
But whatever.
Nothing special about Tucson.
And finally, The Wire on HBO Max. 20 years ago today, the greatest show in the history of television shows premiered on HBO, The Wire.
Is this your take, or was that sarcastic?
It is my take. It is also a very popular take.
It is a very popular take.
The Wire centers around narcotics officers in Baltimore, as well as the criminals they chase. It left no stone unturned in its 5-season run. Government, public schools, news media, all criticized in the series that never won a single Emmy and was only nominated for 2. That's what to watch.
Thank you, Josh.
Mm-hmm.
We are done for today. If you missed anything, check it out, 1620thezone.com. The replay, it's all there. Crossover's next. Talk.
Live from the Host Coffee Studio, this is 1620 The Zone.